they look like a winning football team.
Welcome back to Aggie Memorial Stadium, New Mexico State and Utah State, the 12th all-time meeting. Today's game is presented by First Light Federal Credit Union. It's been a while since New Mexico State has been here at home. For more on that, we welcome in the third member of our crew, and we say hello to Tatiana Favela.
Hey, Adam. Well, the Aggies have been away from their stomping grounds for a little bit over a month, and there were three road games and two bye weeks within that time. Now, the last home game we had here at Aggie Memorial Stadium was against Hawaii, and that did happen a little bit late September, so it's been a minute, and we do have a lot of fans in the stands right now. A lot of people were tailgating right before the game, so we're going to be expecting to see a big crowd presence here and a lot of energy that's happening. Now, again, later on, we're going to catch up with some of the team players and what they were expecting ahead of this game. Adam, Danny.
Thank you, Tatiana. All sideline reports are brought to you by Memorial Medical Center. The keys to the game are presented by the Southwest Chevy dealers. What do you have for us, Danny?
Well, Adam, here's the way I see this breaking down. The offense, we got to win that offensive line battle. You know, all the coaches always say, it starts and stops with the offensive line. In Hawaii, that was the best job they've done at the offensive line. Helped Juwan post his best game ever. We talked about that in the open. When Jonah has time, he makes good reads. He does good things with the ball, both running and passing. Second, strong first down. Got to have a strong first down on defense because that's the number one play where they've really been killing us in the past. And then stop the jailbreak plays. You know, we tied the score at 27 in Hawaii, and then we came back and gave up a long 75-yard TD. We got to stop those jailbreak plays in order to stay in the game and be competitive in the fourth quarter.
Utah State bowl eligible, first place right now in the Mountain West Mountain Division. So this is an out-of-league game for them. And, of course, the Aggies of New Mexico State Independent. And they're looking for their second win of the season and looking for their first this season against an FBS foe. Through the end zone, the Aggies of New Mexico State will have the ball at the 25-yard line. They won the toss. They choose to receive the opening kick. And now we're going to see Jonah Johnson, who, Danny, this year has played pretty well for NM State.
Yeah, you know, early on had some hiccups, but Jonah has really played well. There was a couple pick sixes against Hawaii, but in general, Jonah is playing really good. Coach is calling some really good plays, too. So, you know, we're going to see what happens. If they pack the box, look through the pass. If they don't leave the box packed, he's just going to give the ball off on a run-pass option. Let's see what he calls.
New Mexico State coming off their best rushing game of the season 2 weeks ago before the bye week in Honolulu. And Jonah Johnson was a big part of that, Danny. He ran for 84 against Hawaii. Also ran two scores in, and he picks up three on the first down run.
You know, Jonah's looking very comfortable back there. In this last case, we see that everyone's kind of covered. He could have tried to throw the ball in there somewhere, but instead the middle opened wide, and he just went and took what they gave him. And that's what coach likes to see from the quarterback.
Cole Harity in motion. The Aggies of New Mexico State did not have Omari Samuels against Hawaii. Juwan Price had pretty much all the carries, and he was great. Here's a completion to Cole Harity, the native of Truckee, California, his 19th catch this year.
I like it. They got a little tempo here. Again, starts with that offensive line. Look at how much time they have back there. And when Jonah has the time, the receivers have been able to find those open spots, and they sit down in there, and Jonah's connected just about every single time.
17-yard connection, good enough for a first down. Aggies also without Robert Downs III, wide receiver for the rest of the season. But Jared Wyatt's been great this year, and he hauls in his team best 38th catch. That one goes for 11.
Sitting back in a zone. So with the zone, as long as Jonah has time, we talked about that in the keys, he will find someone. In this case, he is finding all the receivers down there because there's lots of open space in that zone that's so spread out. Let's see if they tighten it up a little bit for the Utah State now.
Wyatt having a breakout year. Grad student from Wiley, Texas, just outside of Dallas. Harity in motion again. The Aggies haven't run it yet. They'll swing it out to Harity. A lot of open field for him. Sneaks away from Shaq Bond initially and creeps up towards the first down marker. A good pass and run for Cole Harity on first down.
Yeah, that's a great job by Cole, but look how comfortable Jonah looks back there. And that's not an easy pass that he makes across the field. He's looking very comfortable back there, Adam. I think he's been as comfortable as we've ever seen him.
Harity gets six, so it's second down and four. Price is to the right of Jonah Johnson. The Aggies will run it for the first time, and Utah State, Danny's coming off a game where they really stopped the run against Hawaii. They only allowed 12 yards on the ground against Hawaii a week ago.
Yeah, you know, I had to go back and look at that stat a couple times. It's like, certainly not. 12 yards, come on. You can get 12 yards just tripping down the field. But they did. They held them to 12 yards. This last play, you know, they certainly had the box stacked, and we're still trying to get someone in there. They have to keep going to the run just a little bit to open that pass up.
And M State, 40% on third down conversions this season. Underneath, it is caught after it might have been deflected. And that is Cole Harry again, his third reception during this opening drive. This one goes for 8.
Yeah, nice. They give him time again. Cole's out there. He runs a little whip route. So it's like a comeback where you get out there, you spin around and come back, and it kind of pins the defender against the sidelines and leaves you the middle wide open. And Jonah was just nice, just put nice touch on that ball right over the middle.
Empty backfield, 5 out wide on a first down. Pass is caught. That's the big tight end. Tomas Whitford rumbles his way down to the 12-yard line.
I've always liked the tight end play because when you're a safety, a free safety, that's usually your guy. And if he's usually blocking most of the time, in this case it's a linebacker, when he's blocking most of the time, you tend to not pay attention. All of a sudden, you think he's blocking and he chips someone and then gets out of there for a pass and usually leaves him wide open across the middle just like that last play.
Only one running back run so far in this opening series for the Aggies, led by Jonah Johnson. Heavy pressure, and Johnson cannot escape. Utah State had a couple of sacks last week against Hawaii, and they had a few players get to Jonah quickly.
They did. So in this case, they're not going to let Jonah sit back there and pick him apart. It gets a little tougher when you get down here close to the red zone, and you can see the pressure. Jonah did the right thing and just eat the ball because you're in good position. You can put points on the board. Let's fight another day. So he just ate the ball. Last week, no sacks. This week, this is our first one. But they're a tough team, and up front there, they're going to come get Jonah. They're not going to let him sit back there.
Utah State had a season-high 5 sacks against Hawaii last week, and A.J. Vongpichon, the linebacker, was the first to get to Jonah. He lost 11 on the previous play. He'll step up. He'll tuck it, and he'll run again. He's a big dude, weighs about 240, and he can really, really move with that 240-pound body.
Yeah, when you're coming up from the secondary and you have someone with 240, and I don't care if he is a quarterback, that is a load. So first of all, let's see what happens. Everyone's covered. It's wide open. He sees that he can go get 6, 7, 8 yards, and he does that. Tries to, you know, make a little move on him as well. I like it.
Jonah gets those 11 back. He picks up 11 on the run. He's back to the original line of scrimmage. Third down and 10. Empty backfield. Designed run for Johnson. Trying to navigate his way through, and he's wrapped up there by Michigan transfer Hunter Reynolds. Looks like the Aggies will kick the field goal.
So they came back and tried to really spread people out. So we had receivers on both ends, really, really at the end of the sidelines, thinking, okay, he's going to open the middle. He's going to come back, fake the pass, and run it. Nothing there. I think they read that one the whole time.
26-yard field goal try here for Ethan Albertson. Out of the hold of the punter, Josh Carlson. Albertson 10 for 14 this year. And it's blocked. Albertson trying to scoop it up. It is pounced on the turf, and that is a big stand for Utah State. It was a great drive to start. The sack by Vongpichon kind of put things out of whack, and then a blocked field goal, and Utah State's feeling good now.
Yeah, it kind of lets the air out of the sails, doesn't it? You go all the way down the field, and someone just gets skinny and cuts right between two offensive guys. Down there on the line, what they do is you try to just hook. You're trying to get everyone to block down and turn their body, and let's see where we can see it. I think it's going to come from the left side of the screen. You can see it right there. We just didn't come down. He got skinny, came across there, unblocked, and he was able to get through there and block the field goal.
And it goes to show, too, Danny, that nothing's automatic. That was a 26-yarder. I'm sure a lot of folks think, well, you just put 3 points on the board and nothing is automatic. And kudos to Utah State on special teams for sticking with it. Logan Bonner's the quarterback. He dumps it off to his top target, one of the best in the country, Devin Tompkins. Danny is second in the nation, averaging 137 receiving yards per game.
Yeah, you know, at 5'8", 155, too, he's really done some great things. You know, he's able to just get up there and get the ball no matter what happens.
They'll give it to Elion Noah. They're going to use probably four backs. Noah and then Pilate Makakona. John Gentry and Calvin Tyler Jr. have all seen a lot of carries this year for Utah State. Third down and short. Right back to Noah, and I don't think he got it, Danny. I think he was stuffed by Kayla Mills. Chris Ojo also there, and Trevor Brohard finishes off Noah.
Yeah, we talked about Chris Ojo and some of the other linebackers in there. Caleb Mills has really come along. I did spend some time with Coach to talk about Caleb Mills and how he's gotten better and better. Here he is around the ball. You get there and you try to push him back. That's a good stop right there.
Huge stop for the New Mexico State defense, which has been inconsistent all season. They've had some good moments and some tough moments as well. Utah State has tried a number of fake punts this year. Just keep that in mind. Steven Kotzenlee boots it away. Lawrence Dixon is back deep for NM State. He calls for a fair catch. And he backpedals near the 20. They'll mark him at the 23. So the New Mexico State offense is back to work. First quarter from Aggie Memorial. Responsible Gaming Association of New Mexico, the state's Native American-owned casinos, working together to offer free and confidential resources for the prevention, education, and treatment of problem gambling. Learn more at rganm.org. Adam Young, Danny Nee, the former Aggie DB, and Tatiana Favela with you from Aggie Memorial Stadium. New Mexico State finally back home after 42 days away from home, and Utah State now bowl eligible at 6-2, and they are undefeated on the road, 3-0 on the road this year. NM State had a good drive to start. It was stalled, though, because of a blocked kick by Utah State. Jonah Johnson was 5-for-5 during the opening series. Native of Madera, California, he's a junior. 240 passing yards per game, and we get a false start.
That's a tough one there. You can kind of see what's happening. They came out the first series and really were all in. They were mostly a zone defense back there. Now they come back.
False start, number 54, offense. 5-yard penalty, first down.
So there you see the call right there. But in the first series, they were in a zone. So now they've come back out and come out of that two deep zone and moved to a man high. And it leaves you in a man coverage. And that means they're going to go get Jonah. They're not going to allow him to sit back there and have as much time as he would like.
Johnson back to throw. He has to run again. Makes a man miss. That was Metzenheimer, and then he slides wisely. His slide started at the 29, so that's where they mark him. But he was able to make Kevin Metzenheimer miss.
Yeah, that's
he's mobile. That's
great running right there. Part of what happens when you come to on blitzes to get the quarterback, if you miss or if you everyone's in man and there's no one accounting for the quarterback.
Here's Juwan Price. He finds a hole trying to bounce it to the edge and then cuts it up inside. He gets the first down up to the 40. Good pickup for Price. It goes for 11.
Boy, he's looking faster and faster as the year goes on. You know, you get to this part of the season, and it's usually get little nagging injuries slow you down and kind of hinder your game a bit. But from Juwan, look how fast he hits that hole, and he bounces to the outside and picks up some very good yardage. He's looking quicker and faster as the season goes on.
Price coming off a career game. That was 2 weeks ago. He was fresh in Honolulu against Hawaii. Almost had 200 all-purpose yards. Johnson with a burst, and he's into Utah State territory. He looks really comfortable out there, Danny.
Yeah, so you can see what's happening. They're going to be in man, and they're going to either go get Jonah or they're going to sit back there. What the problem is that Jonah will run the ball, and he's had some good balls. He good times where he can run it. In this case, he's able to come there, get a little high-step action, little juke in there, and he's able to get some extra yards. He's looking very comfortable back there. So if that's open all day long, you're going to take it. You got to take whatever they give you.
Johnson all the way down to the Utah State 47. Making his fifth consecutive start. Dealt with a wrist injury early on in the season. Had a couple of rushing touchdowns against Hawaii. He has four for the season. He can do both run and throw. Throws this pass to Andre Bodison. Bodison really coming on late in his career, Danny. That's his 21st catch of the season, and it goes for 9 yards.
Yeah, it's nice to have multiple receivers out there that can catch a lot of balls. You know, last game against Hawaii, he caught 5. You had Isaiah catch 6. You had Jared catch 5. That's spreading the ball out, and there's not one guy you can key on because anyone can catch the ball. That's a good job spreading it out.
New running back is Escobar. Doesn't matter. It's Johnson who hurdles a defender, and he hurdles down to the 26.
Watch a little NFL on his spare time there. He comes down there. Someone goes low. Let's see if he goes low at his legs, and it's like, yeah, I'll cut him down low, and he goes over top to hurdle him. I'm not sure Coach would want him to do that, but it's what happens in the game. That's a good job by Jonah.
That was Monte McGarry, who he hurdled over. McGarry spent a few weeks in the New Mexico State program during the offseason before he transferred to Utah State, and Jared Wyatt snags another. That's good for an Aggie first down, all the way down to the Utah State 11.
Jonah's back there feeling very comfortable. They have a blitz that they're going to go get him. He sees it, feels it, and gets rid of the ball quickly before the blitzer had a chance to get to him. That's kind of what you have to do when you can feel it, is like get rid of the ball immediately. Now, it's nice to have someone wide open.
First and 10 from the 11. Utah State trying to sub some new guys in. It's Juwan Price stacked behind Jared Wyatt near side of your television screen. And now Price will motion back into the backfield. So four out wide on first and 10. They give it to Price, makes a man miss. He darts into the end zone. Juwan Price, touchdown New Mexico State.
Now we talked about all the good blocking that he's had. And there has been great blocking. Again, good blocking this time. But a lot of this, Adam, I think this is Juwan. I think there's a linebacker that's assigned to him. Let's see number 10 right there is assigned to him. He has to make the tackle. Juwan sees that. He throws a great move on him. That's all Juwan right there getting TD. That's a nice job.
Danny, he is shifty. And it seems like the last couple of games, ever since that first bye week, Juwan Price has had a little extra burst to his step.
Man, that almost got blocked right there too. But man, he's looking fast.
Juwan Price had 2 rushing touchdowns 2 weeks ago in Honolulu. His 6th rushing touchdown of the season. The Peoria, Arizona native puts NM State ahead by a score. We're back with you here at Aggie Memorial Stadium. New Mexico State, 2 good drives, Danny. Only 7 points to show. But even that first drive, which resulted in a blocked 26-yard field goal try, they moved the ball easily then as well.
And it's still coaches calling a great game because in those cases, you're still finding guys that are out there, offensive lines doing a good job. In certain cases, Jonah's taking the ball and running it himself, and he's got some great running. He's just looking very comfortable back there.
Juwan Price with an 11-yard touchdown run. For more on him, we send it down to Tatiana Favela.
Hey, Adam. Yeah, that's right. We heard from running back Juwan Price last week after having an outstanding game against Hawaii. Now, Price had 17 rushes, 159 yards, and 2 really long-run touchdowns, his best of the season yet. Now, Adam, you spoke with him on the Aggies Coaches Show last week, and he was telling you that he feels good about this last game and after having that rest with the bye week for this game ahead. So, that practice into coming into this game, he says that consistency is key, and that involves at practice as well. So we'll definitely keep an eye on how he does here this afternoon against Utah State. His goal in the final 4 weeks is just to be ahead of the game and ruin other teams' schedule and their game plan. So we'll go ahead and see how that goes. Adam, Danny, back to you.
Thank you, Tatiana. So far, so good. All sideline reports are brought to you by Memorial Medical Center. Breakout season for Price, and we have to remember, too, he is only a freshman. He's a redshirt freshman having a great year. This is Devin Tompkins on the return as a flag flies in. The Aggies are trying to kick away from Savon Scarver, who the last couple of seasons has been arguably the most dangerous return man in the country with 7 career kick return touchdowns.
Yeah, I think that's the guy you certainly do not want to kick the ball to.
Our referee today is Derek Anderson.
During the return, hold number 12 of the receiving team. 10-yard penalty from the end of the return, first down.
All right, that is on Ajani Carter, Jr. out of Houston. 7-0, New Mexico State in a rematch of the 2017 Arizona Bowl. Sports Accessories has the best Aggie gear in town at the best price. Check out their showroom in Las Cruces or visit the online store at theaggieshop.com. Utah State football late in quarter number one. New Mexico State ahead 7-0, and you have to love the start for Doug Martin's crew so far, Danny.
It's a great start. They've essentially went the whole length of the field twice. Now, they got 7 out of it. Should have had a little bit more, but, hey, so you got 7. Importantly, too, Adam, as we talked about, is the defense had a 3-and-out. So the defense is doing very good. They have to continue to hold their ground.
Ball will start at the 17 for Utah State due to the penalty on the kickoff. Utah State this season averaging 31 points per game. They posted 51 a week ago against Hawaii. They're undefeated this year on the road. Here's Calvin Tyler Jr., who's missed the last 2 games due to injury. He gets 4. He's their top ball carrier this year, Danny. He's a transfer from Oregon State.
Yeah, he runs the ball good, but it really starts on that offensive line up front there. So you can see the line over there just hat on hat and then just put someone on the linebacker, and Caleb Mills has to feel to make a tackle.
Bonner will pull it. Donovan King poked it away. It's loose on the turf. And it looks like Utah State pounced on it. Now, Danny, in the last game, New Mexico State forced 5 fumbles, only recovered 2. They couldn't get to it again.
Yeah, same thing here. So, you know, you only got 2, but still the important thing is you've got to be out there creating havoc, creating these fumble opportunities. And the nice thing is look at all the hats, the New Mexico Aggies hat on the ground trying to get the ball.
Third down and long. Utah State needs the 27. Aggies show pressure up the middle. Brohard gets to Bonner, and the pass is incomplete. Chris Ojo, if he turned around, may have had a pick.
Yeah, he could have had a pick. You're right. I think he got lost in coverage. But part of that is all Trevor Brohard. Trevor Brohard missed the Hawaii game, back now. And you can see the importance of having him back. When I talked to Coach Sukup, his position coach, about that, he's just all about Trevor. Trevor's a great guy. Great athlete, and in that case, he put on the pressure. He had to release the ball quickly and got us to a 3-and-out. That's his 2nd 3-and-out.
Danny, you talked to his uncle earlier this week. We'll have a couple of stories later on during the telecast, some really good ones about what Trevor was like growing up. An outstanding young man out of Los Lunas, New Mexico. Back from injury, battling a knee injury the last couple of weeks. Lawrence Dixon calls for fair catch. No, he doesn't. He never whistled for a fair catch, or I should have said flagged for a fair catch, and he's sent out of bounds just outside the 30.
Yeah, that's the toughest position on the field, is that getting the punt return, because you have to make sure you catch the ball and secure it when people are just moving down the field ready to light you up. And in that case, he didn't fair catch it, and it's like, hey, you're fair game. But he was able to get the ball and give us good field position by doing that.
New Mexico State back on offense. They're averaging 24 points per game this season, but the last handful of games have been much improved. 28-plus points in each of the previous 3. They scored 34 in the island, which is really tough to do. Johnson across the middle. There's Tomas Whitford sandwiched in between 3 Utah State defenders. It was Vong Pachon and Lampkin taking him down.
Oh, I love that tight end play. I can't say that enough. But here it is right here. He releases out. Linebacker has him. He's in front of the free safety. And Jonah just threads the ball right between there and just dumps it quickly. Nothing you could do about it.
Second catch here in the first quarter for Whitford. Transfer from Monroe Junior College. Johnson swings it out quickly. Cole Harity. He's been busy. That's his 4th reception, and he has pushed back. But they'll give him forward progress up to the Looks like the 43-yard line. He gets 8 yards on the catch.
You know, everyone says, well, here's a quick screen. Well, why do you throw so many quick screens? I mean, it seems like it's boring and they're going to make a tackle. It's true. But when they play off him like they did and you throw the ball out there quickly, he can go get 8 yards. That's as good as a good first running play for 8 yards. That works. You can do that all day long.
Johnson unofficially 9 for 9. Here's Juwan Price inside the 30. Another big explosion run for the redshirt freshman.
Nice read by Jonah to give the ball. Good blocking up front by those big hosses up front there. Look at up front there. Nice blocking. Good read by Jonah to hand the ball off. And Juwan just feeling stronger and stronger. Good run.
Outstanding mix of pass and run so far from head coach and offensive coordinator Doug Martin. Johnson lofts the pass near side towards the pylon. It's incomplete. Looks like he was looking for Juwan Price on the wheel route there. No, that was Amari Samuels who's in for the first time today.
Yeah, so he misses that pass, but he misses it deep and outside. That's where you want to miss it when you're throwing that back shoulder fade. You're trying to sneak him out of the backfield, but they saw that coming and nothing there. So Jonah just did the right thing and got rid of the ball. And here we are at second down.
That is Samuels in the slot. Now he'll motion into the backfield to the left to Johnson. First carry in a couple weeks for Omari Samuels, and he has nowhere to go. He's still trying to get rolling here, Danny. He came in with so much promise, a transfer from Michigan, former four-star. He was the New Mexico Gatorade Player of the Year, and 64 carries for 202 for the year.
Yeah, there's nothing he could do there. We missed a block up front, and so after all the great accolades we gave that offensive line, we just miss it completely. And when you miss it and you're on the guy who's getting the handoff, nothing you can do, nothing he could do with that.
NM State 1 for 2 today on a third down. Front side pressure from Bannerman. Johnson will throw, and he had a man. It was Jared Wyatt, but he skipped it to him.
Yeah, that could have been trouble either way. You know, so nothing happening there. He's scrambling to keep the ball alive, keep the play alive, and he just forces one out there. Just glad that nothing bad happened when you do that, because there was nowhere open, right? So here he is scrambling. You can kind of see no one's open to get to the ball. So he steps up in the pocket and gets it out there anyway. So puts us in a field goal position, though. So here we go.
45-yard try for Albertson. This would be his season-long. Previous season-long, 44, last game at Hawaii. The kick is up, and it is true. Good hold for Carlson. Good boot for Albertson. New season-long for the big 253-pound kicker from San Diego.
Yeah, you know, on those plays, you have to have three things, right? Have to have a good snap, a good hold, and a good kick. And they did all those things and held everyone out. Nice kick.
Westar is a proud supporter of Aggie Athletics. Find them online at weststarbank.com. We've seen Jonah Johnson have some good quarters, some good halves, and some good games this year, Danny, but, I mean, he's doing everything right now at quarterback for New Mexico State.
He is, and he absolutely knew where he was in the game. In the last play, he made sure that, you know, he could get rid of the ball and still leave us in a position to make this field goal, at least go after this field goal, which we did and completed. So, Jonah, I think you're right, Adam. I think this is the best we've seen him play in a long time. And he's just feeling comfortable back there. He looks very at ease at everything, at running, stepping up in the pocket. It's nice, but it's good when you have good receivers and runners.
Certainly helps, too, when you have two bye weeks and then just one game sandwiched in between. This will be a return for Scarver. He has 7 career kick return touchdowns, and he's pushed out of bounds into the Aggie sideline by Ferguson, but there is a flag down near the 30.
Just makes your heart kind of start when you see that, because it reminds us of the Huntley times, right?
Holding, and others number 10 of the return team. 10-yard penalty. First down, Utah State.
And Scarver, Danny, has done some damage against New Mexico State in the past. This was back in 2017, the Arizona Bowl. Scarver was playing then for Utah State a long time ago. He had his first of 2 career kick return touchdowns against New Mexico State. He would have one the next season in 2018 in Logan. That also was his first career kick return touchdown total. and he's gone on to have six more. He has seven career, which ties the FBS record.
Wow, he's very swift, very fast, makes a very dangerous kick returner.
Bonner will throw a screen pass to his roommate, Bowling. And Brandon Bowling is a yard shy of the first down marker. He picks up nine on the catch and run. Just like Bonner, the quarterback, Brandon Bowling came to Utah State from Arkansas State with head coach Blake Anderson. Utah State will go at tempo. Tompkins catches, and then he's bumped, but he does get the first down. That's his second catch of the day.
Yeah, same type of play. So coaches are, if it's working, they're going to stay with it. In that case, if you don't have enough guys out there, they're betting on their players to make the plays. And if it's just 2-on-2 or 3-on-3, I think Coach Anderson says, we have good players, and we'll take those odds, and we'll throw the ball out there and let them go get extra.
When Utah State's at their best offensively, they're playing with great tempo. They want to play fast. They'll fake the jet sweep. They hand it off to Calvin Tyler Jr., who once again missed the previous two games, but he does return today, and he's had 100 carries this year to lead the team.
Yeah, they got multiple good running backs back there, and it always starts with that big line up front that does a very good job.
And that is the end of one quarter.
This is the end of the first quarter.
Well, a really good quarter for New Mexico State, but we've been here before. Think back to the San Diego State game early this year. Can New Mexico State keep the foot on the pedal? We'll see in quarter two. High school students, New Mexico State's scholarship priority date is fast approaching. You must apply and be admitted before December 1st to be considered for the school's top scholarships. Don't delay. Go to apply.nmsu.edu. New Mexico State University, be bold, shape the future. Well, so far, New Mexico State, 82 rushing yards, only 4 for Utah State, 105 through the air for NM State, 18 through the air for Utah State. Doug Martin's crew has dominated this game so far, Danny.
Yeah, I think that our defense is doing a great job out there. They have 2 3-and-outs. That helps because then you end up with more possession time on with the ball, and then you're able to get stats like you just saw or heard.
Second down and 7. Logan Bonner and Utah State will change the direction of the field they will go in, and we get a flag coming in.
Offside, number 10, defense with contact. 5-yard penalty, second down.
That's our Lazarus Williams, junior from Olympia, Washington. We should note as well that on the left side of that line, number 98, that's Marcus Buckley, who finally has returned, playing in his first game of the season. Danny, he was impactful for the Aggies a couple years ago.
Yeah, you can't have enough big guys on that line that are really making a difference.
Aggies show heavy pressure. Pass is caught by Bowling. He breaks an initial tackle, and then he's wrestled out of the bounds by Ocho. He broke the tackle of McCullough to start the play.
You know, I talked to Coach Bell from New Mexico State. He's a secondary coach, and we talked about the tackling in the secondary, and he said, you know, that's something we got to really try to focus on and fix, and a lot of it has to do with the angle that you're taking to the ball. In this case, you saw Chris Ocho, the linebacker, of course, taking a good angle, so he missed the first hit, but the second, Chris is there with a good angle to the ball to make the tackle.
Timeout on the field. Officials.
So an officials timeout on the field with third down and short coming up for Logan Bonner and Utah State. And we'll step aside as well. Early on in quarter two, touchdown run Price, field goal Albertson, 10-0 New Mexico State. Six and two, Utah State trailing New Mexico State 10-0 here today from Aggie Memorial Stadium, second to last home game for NM State. 14:34 left here in quarter number two, and Danny, right now the defense is trying to stand tall once again. They've been good so far, but trying to limit those explosion plays that have been a big issue this year.
Yeah, those jailbreak plays will kill you, and so far they've been able to do that, and part of it is that they've not let Logan feel comfortable. So keeping the Utah State quarterback in a position where he has to get rid of the ball, where he can't get comfortable. When I talked to Coach Bell, the secondary coach, he told his group, look, you're going to be challenged today because that is a great quarterback over there. I mean, he had a career high against Hawaii last weekend, and so there he is right there. And so he challenged his group that says, look, this is a challenge. Step up and take the challenge. You know you're going to get attacked by him. Let's do this thing. He's a great guy. I just love speaking with him. He's just a great motivator. I would have loved to play for him.
A lot of energy for Brian Bell right there, the secondary coach. Third and short for Utah State. A very efficient 45% this year on third down. They go with two running backs. Bonner, very vocal at quarterback. He's a grad junior from Rowlett, Texas, just outside of Dallas. Looks like the Aggies jump. Bonner might be a free play. He'll lob it down the sideline. It's almost hauled in. Derek Wright got a hand on it, and we get a flag in the secondary as well. So multiple flags on the turf right now. This might have been a free play here for Bonner.
Yeah, so we jump, so you get that one for sure. And then there was a flag, not the official you just saw to the right of your screen, but one to the
There are two fouls on the defense.
And they're back.
Offside, number 96.
For that.
That is decline. Pass interference, number 7. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. Automatic first down.
So the penalty that is taken is the PI on DJ McCullough. The other penalty was on freshman nose tackle Garrett Bishop. And Utah State will slide into New Mexico State territory after the pass interference call.
I think that's the hand battling that you hear so much about. There wasn't a lot of advantage one way or the other, but nonetheless, it's a penalty.
Tyler Jr. runs to the left, trying to get towards the sideline. He's taken down by Bishop. So we've seen Tyler so far, and Elion Noah. Still haven't seen John Gentry or Pilate Makakona. Last game for Tyler was back on October 16th at winless UNLV, a game that Utah State almost lost. Front side pressure, quick dump off. Tackle is broken by Devin Tompkins, and he's taken down there by the 6'5 safety, Caleb Mills. Big play for Utah State.
You know, Tompkins has big numbers, and you can kind of see why he has big numbers. We have him pinned, but he still is able to get off and make a big play out of it right there. Got to make that tackle.
Utah State will go quick. Passes out of the reach of the 5'8" Devin Tompkins, who's not big, but plays a lot bigger than 5'8".
He reminds me of Chris Williams. Chris Williams played for the Aggies back in the 2006 era from Rio Rancho, New Mexico, and he just always making plays. Chris was too, and so does Tompkins. He's got great numbers, and clearly you can see why you want to make sure you know where that guy is at all times on the field.
5'8", 155 is what Tompkins is listed at. Their second best wide receiver, Brandon Bowling's only 5'9". Bonner will throw near side. He's looking for Tompkins, and he can't make the catch. Good coverage there by linebacker Josh Ferguson.
Josh Ferguson, that's a tough job having to cover him. And so he does well, though. He stayed with him. He made sure he wasn't going to battle him because they've already thrown a penalty, a flag on that, a PI. So in this case, he just ran with him the whole time, nothing doing.
And M State trying to hold Utah State to a field goal try. Although if they get to fourth down, they might go for it. They go for it on fourth down as much as anybody in the country. So this could be four down territory. You never know. Bonner, run pass option, hooks up with Van Leeuwen, and he is stopped shy of the marker. So we'll see if Utah State will keep the offense on the field. Initially, it looks like they will.
Yeah, that's a nice tackle by Trevor Brohart. He was out there all the while, nothing long, but making sure-handed tackles.
Utah State, eighth nationally in fourth down conversions this year. They are 13 for 22 on fourth down this year. They need the eight. Aggies almost jumped. No flag. Pass is incomplete.
I think they threw one down low.
They did
low
throw
here.
One. It was Chris Ojo who was barely over that line of scrimmage.
I think Utah State knows they're coming and knows that he's not going to let them sit back there.
Offside, number 3, the defense. It's a 5-yard penalty. Still fourth down.
That's what you do on an offense when you have a blitzing linebacker or a blitzing team. You want to keep them off kilter a bit. You stagger the counts. You come up with quick counts. You come up with long counts. But a lot of it has to be sold by the quarterback and how he's out there just barking out the signals. In this case, we've had three already. So now they really have to dig their heels in here.
Looks like fourth and inches here. And, of course, Utah State will go for this. They hand it off to Tyler. Might depend on the spot.
Yeah.
Aggies are going to say that they think they didn't get it. Spot doesn't appear to be great. They will likely measure this, Danny.
Which will be interesting because didn't we have the chains on the far side of the field break that you were pointing out earlier on a break? And so we'll see what happens. Or did they give it to him? No, I think he was calling for a measurement.
Well, that line judge was, it didn't seem like it was going to be a favorable spot.
So you can see the line judge coming in right, not at the very end, but a little bit before. There he is right there. You can kind of see him. It's got the spot. Hand him the ball right there, and that's where he's going to mark it. Holy smokes.
New Mexico State football. They bend a little bit, Danny, but they don't break.
You know, I had some stats I was trying to keep track of on defense to say, well, how many three and outs can we get to? How many first downs, you know, of less than 3 yards? Now I got a new one. Fourth down stops, very important here. That is just a fantastic job by that defense to just bow their neck and not let anyone in.
Field position not great, but the New Mexico State offense will take it. Support Aggie student athletes by joining the Aggie Athletic Club. The AAC prepares student athletes for life during and after their careers at NM State. For more info, visit AggieAthleticClub.com. Right back to action. The Aggies pinned deep. This is Juwan Price, and he is swung down by Justin Rice, among others. Rice, the middle linebacker, is one heck of a player. Former Fresno State Bulldog and Arkansas State Red Wolf.
Yeah, that's going to challenge this offensive line. When they have you pinned deep in your own territory, there's not a lot of plays that come to mind that you can try to push out a little bit. So you kind of know it's going to be a run. But then after the run, they're going to have to throw the ball. We are, in order to get some more distance in there to at least get a good punt off. So let's see what happens.
Need to be careful. Johnson is on the edge of his own end zone, and he's able to get out of that end zone. But this is dangerous territory right now for the Aggie offense.
Yeah, I couldn't tell if that was a run-pass option or if that was just a keeper all the while in there. And so it looks like they're blocking up front. It's kind of hard to tell, but, man, that's a tough one right there.
At the very least right here, you would like some more breathing room for Josh Carlson, your punter. Right now, Johnson is in the end zone on third down. And a drop back to throw. He will throw it into double coverage, and it's too long for Isaiah Garcia Castaneda. So now you have to worry about some bad stuff happening here, including a safety, as Carlson's going to kick it out of the end zone, in the back side of the end zone, more than likely.
Yeah, and so you end up with the punt team up front. That line really has to block. You saw that on a field goal attempt, the first one down the field at 26 yard. Someone shimmied through a couple guys easy. In this case, you know, I think they're going to bring them. I would bring them all because we are pinned deep. You don't even have your normal distance for the punter, so he's going to have to get it, kick it quickly.
You just saw Isaiah Garcia Castaneda limp off the field and also holding his hamstring area on the Aggie sideline, so we'll continue to monitor that. Carlson will kick. When we come back from break, the Aggies blanking Utah State. New Mexico State back home for the first time in 42 days, but it's been a busy week here at New Mexico State. For more on that and the move to Conference USA for all sports, we head down to Tatiana Favela.
Adam, that's right. After that unanimous vote from NMSU Board of Regents, New Mexico State is officially joining Conference USA. And that's for all sports now. The last football game Aggies played as conference members was the 2017 Nova Home Loans Arizona Bowl, taking the win in front of 25,000 Aggies and fans. So the conference will provide access to funding that will benefit New Mexico State athletic teams and 400 student athletes. Very exciting news for NMSU. Adam, Danny.
Thank you, Tatiana. All sideline reports are brought to you by Memorial Medical Center. This is great news, Danny, for a number of reasons, but most notably football. Finally able to get back into a league after leaving the Sun Belt a couple of years ago, going independent. Only one more independent season left after this season, and then they can head to Conference USA as Carlson boots it away to Jordan Nathan, and he hauls it in on the fair catch.
Yeah, going to Conference USA, you know, we talked about all the movement in the first season of the game, right? So way back when, we said, hey, look, there's going to be a lot of movement going on. It all started with Texas and OU saying, yeah, you know, I'm going to the Southeast Conference, and everyone started moving chairs.
Kick catch interference, number 47, kicking team. 15 yards added to the end of the kick, first down.
Yeah, just enough contact there. That'll do it.
Yeah, you got to give them lots of room there. It was a quick hand, too. But back to the Conference USA. So this move really puts us in a good spot because now we have a conference that allows you to go out and recruit people so you can start building these relationship and these competitive teams that you're going to be playing. And you can, you know, it just really helps all the way around. So I think this is good stuff. I'm very excited, as most previous players. We're looking for this and excited that it's happening.
Should be a good league. New Mexico State, Liberty, Jacksonville State, and Sam Houston State just added yesterday. This is Elion Noah. Only his third carry. This one goes for 5 yards, his longest run of the day.
You know, defense is really being challenged. This is a tough one here where you're pinned deep and you kick and then you have a penalty and it really puts them in good field position. So the defense is going to have to earn their keep here.
Logan Bonner, 6 for 9, 44 yards so far through the air. Had a fumble earlier, but it was scooped up by one of his offensive linemen. The Aggies have shown a lot of pressure defensively. Noah, again, trying to find a hole. There's nowhere to go, and Donovan King rips him down. I think you were worried maybe about a horse collar or a face mask, right?
I was, but I like the fact that Donovan King was standing tall. He's like, fine, you bounce outside. This is my area of operation. Nothing happening here. Donovan King rips him down to the ground, so that's a great job.
Utah State 0-for-3 on a third down. This is 3rd and 4. Big difference so far in time of possession. Bonner to the air, he has a man, and it's hauled in. Devin Tompkins, a touchdown. He's only 5'8", but he can sky through the air.
He goes up for the ball, so I know that, and even the press conference, Coach Martin said, you know, they throw a lot of 50-50 balls up there, and if you have a guy that can sky like Tompkins can, that 50-50 ball, maybe it's not 50-50, maybe it's more 60-40, but he went up. We had two guys in coverage on that. We had them boxed. We had top and bottom covered on that. He had to get rid of the ball quickly and make a play, but we have guys there, and he's still able to pull that down.
Point after from Connor Coles out of the hold of punter Steven Kotzenlee. And it's good. So Utah State on the scoreboard. Devin Tompkins hauls in his 7th receiving touchdown of the season. Bonner throws his 18th and his 48th career. It's a 3-point game in Las Cruces. Beasley Mitchell and Company, certified public accountants, are proud supporters of the Aggies. Bookkeeping, auditing, tax and estate planning, and more. Let the experts at Beasley Mitchell and Company tackle your taxes. Only 3 plays, 28 yards, a minute 15, that followed the Carlson punt, which included a kick catch interference call, and the penalty really hurt New Mexico State, Danny. That was horrible field position for the NM State defense.
Right. So the whole purpose of punting is that you want to flip the field and get field position back to you because you're kicking the ball out. In this case, we were deep in our own, pinned deep. We couldn't have as much time to get the kick we wanted. It wasn't as deep of a kick. Had a penalty after that. Gave him good field position. But Tompkins, man, what a catch. So we got a game.
That's Terrell Warner back deep with Juwan Price. Usually Garcia Castaneda is back there, but he might be dealing with a hamstring injury right now. We saw him tugging on his hammy earlier on the sidelines, and he limped off. So Terrell Warner will now return kicks for the time being with Juwan Price. We like what we have seen so far from the NM State offense. Right now, 181 yards of offense, 105 through the air for Johnson, 76 on the ground. Those are some outstanding statistics, and woulda, coulda, shoulda, they probably should have more than 10 points, but they still lead here early on in quarter two.
It's a scrapping fight right here, and so coach said, you know, they're going to score, which they are. We just got to figure out a way to score back, to volley back.
Aggies will throw on first down, and Price had tons of open space. If he could have gotten away from that tackle there, that was made by Michael Onyonwu for a loss of two.
So a quick pass. The idea is get the ball out to Price, who we know is very fast in open field, but he didn't have a chance to even turn and make a move on him. The defense was just on him, closing so quick. There's nothing to do with that play.
Defense playing a little bit better now for Utah State. Motion man is Harity. Johnson throws it to Harity. Last minute decision. And Cole Harity tiptoes around the sidelines. He was bumped out of bounds by Monte McGarry.
You know, when you have lots of time and you're running and you're moving and you come to the line of scrimmage, they're not sure if he's going to keep the ball or not. So this really freezes the defense. And as he comes to the line of scrimmage, he dumps the ball quickly out there. And Cole got some great yardage.
Third down, 1 yard to go. It was a gain of 11 for Harity. Five catches, 49 yards now for the Truckee, California native. Johnson will keep it. Spot looks pretty good initially, Danny. I think they got it.
You know, the thing, I'm just so impressed with Jonah because he's playing within himself, but he knows where he is on the field and he knows where he is with the score. Third down short. He knows he's got to get a couple of yards in there. Good defense. He's close. He feels it. He stretches the ball out there. That's a great job.
The ability there to stay patient and not rush it, impressive as well, and it does move the chains. Price in the backfield, Johnson steps up and throws. Another catch for Harity, then it pops loose. They're gonna rule it an incompletion, which is not good news for New Mexico State because Juwan Price got to it. NM State would have had the ball at the 50.
Pressure on Jonah. Jonah gets rid of the ball. Cole catches it, he's in there, but he sandwiched. Not much you can do. You barely have time to secure the ball, and guys are already popping you. Legal hits, but it's just what happens, and the ball bounces out.
So Harity will head off. The Aggies have a number of wide receivers they can recycle in, but they are without Robert Downs III, their top returning receiver entering the season. He's out for the rest of the season with an injury. Johnson, plenty of time to throw, and it's out of the reach of Wyatt, and a late flag comes in. Should be pass interference.
I think when Jared was making the cut, it was a deep in route, and when he was making the cut.
Pass interference, number 22, defense. Ball will be placed at the spot of the foul, automatic first down.
And Jared had position, so the defender was to the outside. So you can see Jared, as you come to look at it, the defender's to the outside, to the field sidelines time piece, and leaves the middle wide open, and that's where he was moving to, and he was going to make a big catch right there. So yeah, he jumped him a little bit and got caught.
And that was our Michael Onyonwu, who had the tackle for loss against Price earlier in this series. P.J. Johnson, freshman from Lake Charles, Louisiana, was in motion. He's in the slot right. Johnson, pressure behind him. The ball pops loose, and it is jumped on by Utah State. Was he in bounds or was he out of bounds, though? Looked like that was Hale Motuapuaka who jumped on it.
Well, that's
and he was out of bounds.
That's a tough one right here. So from the back, you know, he fumbles the ball. That's the only thing about bouncing around in the pocket, kind of keeping the ball loose like that. You're not sure where the pressure is. You know it's all around you, so you're trying to make your way out. But, you know, it's tough. You have to try to secure it in some way. We get a break there.
NM State catches a huge break as that ball is squirted out of bounds in front of the Utah State sidelines. Home run ball for Johnson, and he almost had his receiver. Flag comes in. It was intended for Garcia Castaneda, so I guess the hammy's okay. Second pass interference call during this drive. for Utah State.
Maybe it's one of those, you know, they're watching me. Oh, it's my hamstring. I'm not going to do it. Oh, but here I am. I'm back. And Isaiah Garcia-Castaneda is very, very fast. So have him back in there. He's the guy you want to go for those deep balls. Jonah, he puts a nice ball out there deep, right? So he misses, but it's going to miss it where no one can catch it except for Isaiah. That's a great job right there.
That PI call is on Andre Grayson, the grad senior from Rancho Cucamonga, California. So the penalties for Utah State moving the NM State drive along. About midway through quarter number two. NM State ahead by three. Quick dump off to Jawan Price, and it's towards his shoe tops.
Oh, Adam, sorry about that. I know I jumped in there, but I saw it. It was coming. They've been going to a single high the rest of this quarter and really pressuring them. So they brought the house, and the perfect play was called. Coach Martin called a screen out to Jawan, the guy we want to have the ball. And it just hit his shoe tops, and he couldn't get it. He catches that. He's gone. That's six.
Second down and 10. Price again in the backfield. Andre Bodison lined up wing right. Johnson looking Price's way. Catch is made, and a good open field tackle for McGarry.
Boy, Utah State is bringing lots of type of disguised rushing, blitzing packages. And they're not letting Jonas sit back there and just have his day. So you can kind of see it right there. The offensive line did a great job of picking up everyone and just getting out to Juwan. Just couldn't quite get it to that first down marker.
Looks like a quick injury timeout. McGarry slow to get off. And NM State will have a big third down and five coming up after Price picks up five on the catch and run. Western Heritage Bank is a proud supporter of Aggie Athletics. Western Heritage Bank, connected to the community and to you. Find them online at westernheritagebank.com. Today's game is presented by First Light Federal Credit Union. Simple, safe, secure. Give First Light the opportunity to show you what better really is. Doug Martin's offense into Utah State territory. Third down and mid coming up. Running back is Alex Escobar. No carries so far for Escobar today. NM State 2 for 5 on a third down. They need 5 yards. Out route, caught, first down. Terrell Warner, his first reception today, his 23rd of the campaign.
Yeah, Terrell is very capable as well. You know, the 6'1", 190 player there is called on to pull this one in and get to that first down marker. First is to make a secure catch, pull it up a little short, but he gets it and pushes to that first down marker. Terrell, that's a great job.
Escobar will stay in on first down and 10. Johnson looks left, he throws left. A lot of space for Harity. Big burst for Cole Harity. Catch number 6 already for Harity. He only had 18 in the first 8 games this year. This one goes for 10.
Yeah, multiple guys open in that pattern. You had one crossing underneath. You had Cole out to the flats here, and he decided to take Cole and get some extra yardage. And they were just back. Look how far back they are. He catches it and gets 6 more yards before they're even there. So lots of pressure, and then lots of open green space, and then the defense is deep.
Escobar still a running back. Here's the first carry today for the former walk-on from Peoria, Arizona, team captain as well, highly regarded within the locker room. 7th carry this year for Escobar, who had 3 last game at Hawaii.
You know, if Alex breaks that one last tackle, there's a lot of ground in there for him to go get some extra stuff in there. So from the backside, someone came off their block to make the tackle.
Escobar only gets 1. Eric Marsh, linebacker, is in wing left right now as a blocking fullback. Rice hurdled a defender. Johnson will angle to the right before he's taken down. Open field tackle there for Cash Gilliam, who plays the star position, which is a linebacker DB hybrid for Utah State.
So two guys in the pattern. You have Max people staying back to protect. You saw someone jump over top of Alex. The two guys
Time
in the
out.
Pattern were
New
covered.
Mexico
Nothing
State.
He could do but try to get whatever
Their
he could from
half.
It.
And this not is much a 30-second timeout.
So Doug Martin will use a timeout here. This is, of course, a big series here in a close game. 10-7 NM State. And by the way, Utah State is no stranger to close games. In fact, this season, Utah State is 4-0 in one-score games. And on the road this year, they're undefeated, Danny. They're 3-0, but they've all been close games. They have three road wins by a total of 11 points at Washington State, at Air Force, and at UNLV. So they're not blowing people out, per se. They're just winning close games this season.
Yeah, they're a good, complete team. Coach Anderson has done a great job, and we've seen Coach Anderson when he was at Arkansas State, so he coaches a good team all the way around. And in close games, if you can win them, that's good. That's good stuff. So it's a very well-coached team, but the Aggies are playing them tough. There's Coach Anderson right there. Came from Arkansas State. We had some great battles with him while he was there. He's doing a great job over the first year there, bowl eligible. Hey, but the Aggs are playing them tough, the New Mexico Aggs.
Blake Anderson took Arkansas State to six straight bowl games. He is 4-0 all time against New Mexico State. First season at Utah State after 7 years with the Red Wolves of Arkansas State. He's been here before at Aggie Memorial. 3rd and 9 for Jonah Johnson. Heavy pressure, picked up well by Escobar. Johnson will stop and throw, pass is caught. What a catch. That is Justice Powers, and a flag is thrown near the 20. That is improv for Jonah Johnson.
That is right there. And so going to get a holding.
An eligible receiver downfield, number 11 of the offense. It's a 5-yard penalty from the previous spot. Third down.
That's tough. And part of what happens is when you have a scrambling quarterback and he breaks containment, you don't know if he's going to go keep running. And if he does, you want to go downfield and get a block. Well, if you're an offensive lineman, you're not allowed downfield, and so you get a whole situation there. But improv, like you're talking about, Adam, that is a great job.
So now it's 3rd and 14 instead of a first down. That would have been Justice Powers' first home catch of the season. Empty backfield for Johnson. He has tons of time to throw, so he throws it underneath. Some yards after the catch is needed here for Terrell Warner, and he can't get down to the 12, which is what they needed. And that's going to bring out Ethan Albertson after Warner gets 9. He needed 14.
Yeah, you know, Terrell saw where he was on the field, and he knew where the marker was. He was trying to pick up that extra block right there. First of all, it starts with the blocking. You have three guys, they drop everyone else, but those three guys are all accounted for. Terrell coming underneath, gets the ball. He knows where he needs to go, and he tries to get an extra block, but he just can't get there. Leaves us short.
Blake Anderson and Utah State will use a timeout here with 4:12 left here in quarter two. 10-7 NM State. In case you're just joining us, NM State led 10-0 after one quarter. 11-yard touchdown run by Juwan Price. 45-yard field goal by Ethan Albertson. And then a 22-yard touchdown catch by Tompkins here in quarter two.
So we talked about the importance of that offensive line where it wins, or it starts and stops there on the right side. Our right tackle just pancake blocks someone there. It gives them lots of time. That's what you need in order to give Jonah lots of time back there. That's a great job by those big hosses up front there.
35-yard try for Albertson, who connected on a season-long 45-yarder late in quarter one. And the kick is right down the middle. Going back to that pancake block, Danny, right tackle has been a big issue for offensive line coach Corey White this year. Left side's been good. Sage Dockstatter grading out as well as anybody around the country on the offensive line. Gabriel Preciado's been good at left guard, and then Eli Johnson is rock solid at center. Carson Ferris playing well at right guard, but right tackle, they've been juggling guys. Doro O'Mary, Stephon Townsend, and now it's Isaiah Mercilot today, and Looks like he's playing pretty well.
Mercilot had him there. There's nothing you can do. That was a pancake block. You know, and I did want to speak to Coach White, the offensive line coach, before this game, because Juwan had a big game last week, which is true. But that line up front did so good. Every big, long play that I saw Juwan break, that offensive line had everyone accounted for. And I talked to Coach White and said, hey, I know you're not going to get lots of kudos from everyone because your guys didn't run it in, but they played a solid game. My hat's off to you. He was proud. He was very proud of those guys. Knew that there's more he could do, but he was very proud of those guys.
And Danny Juwan says all the right things. The first group of people he credits when talking about his game, the big hoss is up front.
The big hoss is up front. It all starts and stops right there. Yeah, that is a smart move by the running back.
Kickoff from Albertson, Scarver, and Tompkins deep in. It's through the end zone. Juwan Price, a humble young man, getting a lot of opportunities this year and taking full advantage. He's run it well here today. 35 yards on the ground for Price, 39 on the ground for Jonah Johnson, who's also 15 of 21 through the air for 143 and zero mistakes so far as turnovers are concerned. When you go back to that Hawaii game 2 weeks ago, Danny, you take away the two pick six return touchdowns, and New Mexico State leaves the island with a huge win against Hawaii.
Yeah, you know, in that game as well, you tie the score at 27 apiece, and then immediately the next play, you give up a huge 70-plus yard run for a TD, which is what I'm thinking here, that you need to make sure that you're staying aware of, that they don't go for it all right on this play.
Logan Bonner, the veteran quarterback for Utah State, completes the pass to Scarver, who's great in the return game, Danny, but that is only his fourth catch this year. He's not used a lot in the offense.
Yeah, first down, there's so much open for the coaches. They can run, they can throw. There's a lot you can do because you have to play balanced, and so you really can't gamble one way or the other. So that's a tough down.
Trickery here, end around for Scarver as he received it from Tompkins. He runs it near side of the field, breaks a tackle before he's finally ripped down by Cyrus Dumas. That's a good idea for Utah State to try to get Scarver some open field.
Jailbreak plays. That's the ones we talked about in the keys of the game, and this is one of them. Little trickery, jailbreak, baby to the outside. You see him, but we just can't get to him, man. He's tough.
Bonner throws it deep, and it's incomplete, looking for his running back, Tyler, and it was a late hit. After the incompletion, that was Cyrus Dumas, who will be whistled for the penalty.
I thought Cyrus was going to come back and try to pick that ball because he saw it after he released from his man. He came back to support, and it's right there.
Personal foul, late hit, number 13 of the defense. 15-yard penalty, an automatic first down.
That's a tough one.
That is so hard to stop your momentum when you're trying to make a play, isn't it, Danny, as a DB like yourself?
When you're going full blast and everything stops all of a sudden and you're leaning forward, it's hard to just say, okay, I'm stopping. Sometimes you just go through. And it's tough now. It's very different than when I played, but my wife ensures me that I would never complete one game with too many late hits if I played today.
Here's El Elyon Noah, and he can't break a tackle at the 40. Gain of three for the sophomore from La Mesa, California.
You know, as this second quarter comes down here, it's important that you have a good series defensively. You can't be just content to say, let's just kind of, you know, play mediocre. First, don't give up the big play, but second, don't let him in the end zone make him kick. So you got to dial something up to keep Bonner on his toes.
Noah, the running back, tight end to the right of the line is Carson Terrell. Now he's in motion left. Aggies will rush four. Bonner looking left, scanning the field. Lofts a pass. It is intercepted.
Yep.
DJ McCullough, team best third pick during his junior year.
You know, Coach Bell, when I was talking to him, he said, I told my guys, it has been too long since we've had a pick. I said, man, you can have some picks this game. Adam and I will be happy for us to call some picks. Here's one right here. The pass, it's really something he shouldn't have thrown. DJ sees it all the while. He sees his eyes. He sees the guy he's going to, and he sticks with that same guy. and he tries to deliver the ball in there, but DJ just spied it and came up, catch the ball at the highest point, as you should, in the secondary, and gets a pick and turns the field. Now it's interesting.
And now you get hungry if you're the New Mexico State offense.
Yeah.
Final 3 minutes here in the half, and now you have a chance to go up a couple scores heading into the locker room at the halftime break.
You know, on that last rewind that you saw, you can see from the quarterback's perspective where he looks open, but you don't just see DJ back there kind of sitting waiting, and he came off his guy to get that pick. Here we go.
Harrity's been busy. He's in motion. Price, the running back, they'll toss it to Juwan Price, makes the catch, open field, and he's dragged down by Michael Onyonwu. 4 yard pickup for Juwan Price, and for him, that is catch number 3 already. Clock moving, 2.5 to go here in the first half. Johnson almost throws an interception. Somehow that's caught by Cole Harrity. I think he faked out the fans who thought either that was incomplete or picked off. But it's Harrity who comes up with it for 8 yards and a first down.
So maybe it's our perspective, Adam, but I was thinking the same thing you were. It's like, oh, man, there's two guys standing right there. Here we go, tempo.
Nowhere to go there for Juwan Price. Nowhere this D-line is big for Utah State.
So back to that other play, I was feeling the same way you do, except maybe the perspective is different from your when you're behind looking down the field as a side that we're looking at it, because it looks like Cole, he was completely covered, nothing there.
Timeout.
And he still managed
Utah
to get the ball in there.
It's their second of the half. Game clock operator, please put 2:06 on the clock. Thank you.
Utah State will use a timeout here. Blake Anderson and the Aggies of Utah State down to 2 timeouts. Doug Martin has 1 timeout to play with. Cole Harrity, 7 catches, 67 yards. He's a young man, Danny, who has been well-traveled. He began his career at Weber State. Then he transferred to Saddleback College. And this was a huge 2-for-1 get for that man, Doug Martin. He brought over Cole Harrity and Isaiah Garcia Castaneda from Saddleback, where Doug has a number of connections going back to his early days in football, and he got 2 very good wide receivers in that package.
And Cole had one too, if we remember. One bounced out of his hands and he took a quick pop on, so he would have even a bigger day, but he is having one whale of a day so far.
So now they put the clock at 2:06. Isaiah Mercilot at right tackle, very vocal, turning around and telling something to Jonah Johnson. There's another catch for Harrity. Give him 8 in the first half. He's on pace for 16 in the game.
Again, lots of blocking up front there. Lots of time by Jonah. He's able to sit back there and see Cole come all the way across the field and make a great pass. He's still got to make a good pass, and he has. He's thrown the ball very good today.
Third down, 5 yards to go. Under 2 left here in the first half. Caught by Bodison, trying to fight for first down yardage. He does. Andre Bodison's second effort, and that will move the chains. He picks up 8.
You know, at 6'5", 205, he's using his body type in there that says, you know what, I'm going to just fight for every single yard. So he sees it right there, feels the pressure. He spins from it and then just fights for extra yardage, which is really going to help this drive. That's a great job.
Aggies inside Utah State territory. Coming straight up the middle is Rice, and I don't know how Johnson got rid of that one, but he finally did, and Justin Rice is one of the top linebackers in the entire country.
Yeah, both sides are not letting the quarterback sit back there, because when they do, you know, bad things happen downfield. Jonah, they're trying to keep the pressure on him. He had to dump it quick, really couldn't do anything. We weren't ready for it. I think it was Juwan that was out there, but just couldn't get in open to see the ball fast enough.
Rice leads Utah State in tackles, tackles for loss, and interceptions. He has 38 career tackles for loss. Front side pressure. Getting away from Vonk Pichon is Johnson. The pass is bobbled and then caught. And that's Garcia Castaneda for 5 yards.
How about Jonah feeling so comfortable back there? You open it up, so it's an empty backfield. There's no running back to pick up an extra blitzer, and they see that Utah State, and they bring someone, and Jonah just steps around him just so nonchalantly, like, okay, I got this.
Aggies need the 33. Johnson stepping up. He's going to try to run for it. Flag comes in, though, and Jalen Bannerman was signaling for a flag as well. He might have been held.
Number 27, Reynolds.
Holding, number 54, offense. 10-yard penalty, third down.
Well, we were just praising Isaiah Mercilot the entire first half in his first miscue of the afternoon.
Yeah, I couldn't see it. We'll take a better look this time around, but you see him on the right side of your screen right there where they're trying to get around the end on him. He may have put his hand out there, his arm out there to hold him up just a bit. I think he did. He got caught. But he has a good job. Looks like he's gasping a bit too. And those guys up front are working very hard. They're expending a lot of energy. Still doing a good job. Still in the drive, though. We're still alive.
Out of field goal range now. Third down and 15. Johnson has all day to throw. Caught by Price. He somersaults just shy of the marker by a yard. That'll be at the 34. Is that in Ethan Albertson's range? Player down right now for Utah State near midfield.
Look at, so we have a pancake block again. So it's a second right there. Coach is going to have to make sure he gets some good kudos for that. Lots of time, hits Price, he spins, they make immediately hit on him, it's close.
How comfortable do you feel here, Danny, kicking a 51-yarder from Albertson? Now he's shown that range, the wind isn't doing much. Do you kick it here or do you go for it on fourth and one?
Number 54, offense. It's a 5-yard penalty, replay third down.
Well,
I guess that's your answer,
right?
That's
a good point now, right?
Yeah.
It was about to be fourth and one. Player down still for Utah State. That's Bannerman. Jalen Bannerman, transfer from Arizona Western Junior College. Started his college career at Kentucky. Grad senior from Pickerington, Ohio. Good to see Bannerman walking off on his own. Bosque Brewing Company is a proud supporter of Aggie Athletics. With two locations in Las Cruces and additional locations in Albuquerque and Santa Fe, Bosque Brewing is the home of Pistol Pete's 1888 Ale. Drink one to the Aggies. Well, now you're in a horrible spot, third and 20. And you're back in your own territory now as well.
Yeah, so I think it puts you back in the playbook of you know what to do as opposed to, oh, I'm not sure. Maybe we go for it. Maybe we kick it. Maybe we don't. But here you kind of know what's going to happen. You're going to try to get as many yards as possible, then take a look at it, but maybe have to punt it away.
Escobar to the left of Johnson. The tight end Whitford to his right. Johnson does have some time. He has a man. And it is incomplete. Justice Powers looking for a flag, and he will get one.
Oh, I think you and I were looking at the same guy crossing the field, right? Saw the same opening there with lots of time back there. He was waiting for him to clear.
Pass interference, number 6, defense. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot, automatic first down.
Pass interference calls aplenty here in the first half for Utah State. That's on Cam Lampkin, junior from Mesquite, Texas, and the drive will continue for offensive coordinator and head coach Doug Martin.
You know, when the receiver turns and goes back into the defender, into the DB, trying to make a play for the ball, they're almost always going to call that.
First and 10 from the 38. Johnson can't elude pressure this time, and he's taken down for a sack. Back at the 44. And a timeout is taken by the Aggies of New Mexico State immediately. Looks like Johnson loses 6 on the sack for Utah State.
That's too bad. 4 guys in the route, all 4 guys covered. They had a man free. You see coach up there talking to Eli Center about who's coming. They brought everyone. So you're in a position where you may not be able to block everyone, and you try to block the guys that are going to be that affect the most to the quarterback, which is tough to guess at when you're on the offensive line. But those guys are doing a great job. Eli's working his butt off there. It's great to have him this season. He's done a great job. Great leader for New Mexico State.
Yeah, Eli Johnson from Taylor, Mississippi, could have chosen a number of different schools, and he comes to New Mexico State. He's a future coach. Loves the game of football, knows the game of football at a very high level. Started all 12 games in 2019 at center for Ole Miss, and He's been fun to watch. He's been fun to get to know. He's just a good person to be around. Positive energy all the time. And it's going to be fun to see what he does in coaching, Danny, because he screams future head coach at a very, very high level.
Yeah, I agree. And the personality, it's one of those that you always want to follow, too. It's like, yeah, absolutely. Let's go wherever he's taking us.
Forty-four-yard line, second down and 16. Under 30 seconds left in a good first half for NM State. And Johnson can't get away again. Offensive line's been pretty good overall in this first half, but breaking a bit here lately. That's a sack for Andre Grayson, his first of the season, the second straight six-yard loss.
Yeah, part of that stunt is they have linebackers kind of crossing, and when you start doing crossing, you can see him right there cross across the middle of Eli's face, and he's picked up, but the guy he releases the other way is the one that broke free and got in the back time.
New Mexico State was having issues trying to line up. They're out of timeouts, and right now only 1 second is on the clock.
Timeout, Utah State. It's their final of the half. 30-second timeout.
So Utah State uses a timeout. Blake Anderson probably worried that might have been a Hail Mary of some sorts, and they weren't lined up properly. But there's only 1 second left. Do you go for it here, Danny? Do you try to toss one towards the end zone, or do you just kind of take a knee?
I think you go for it. I think you put your foot on the gas, and you let it rip, and figure out what's going to happen. Can they catch it? Can they return it? Yes. I mean, could a lot of things happen and they hit the quarterback and he fumbles it? Yes. But where they are, their record, they have them back thinking, you know, that New Mexico State is here to play, and they are. Why not?
Also a chance to see Jonah Johnson showcase his big arm as well. Third and 22, final seconds of the half. And the Aggies will not toss it towards the end zone. They're just going to run it with Juwan Price, and that will close out the first half. It started well in quarter one for New Mexico State, an 11-yard touchdown run by Juwan Price. Ethan Albertson kicked a 45-yard field goal. Tompkins, a 22-yard touchdown catch in quarter two for Utah State. And NM State got another field goal from Ethan Albertson. So 13-7 is our halftime score, and Doug Martin is standing by on the sidelines with Tatiana Favela.
Hey, that's right. We are now joined with head coach Doug Martin. Coach, what are your thoughts going on with this first half right now?
We're moving the ball well, but you know, when we get in the red zone, we're going to need touchdowns, not field goals, and that's the biggest thing right now. And then defensively, we just got to keep playing like we are. This is probably the best game we've played defensively so far.
And what are some adjustments that you're thinking of right now for the second half?
Well, we're going to have to change our pass protections up because we're getting beat up front a little bit. Have to use our running backs and pass protection a little bit.
Well, thank you so much, Coach. Adam, Danny, back to you.
Thank you, Tatiana. All sideline reports are brought to you by Memorial Medical Center, the official healthcare partner of Aggie Athletics. NM State leads here at the halftime break, 13-7. Halftime comes your way next. Six and two, Utah State. They are bowl eligible, but they trail New Mexico State on the road. 13-7 here at the halftime break. Utah State in danger of losing their first road game of this season. They're currently 3-0, undefeated away from Logan, Utah. Halftime stats are presented by Blue Cross and Blue Shield of New Mexico. That first half, Danny, was dominated in a lot of ways by NM State.
Yeah, no doubt about it. And look at the time of possession up there. We got 21 minutes versus 8. It makes a difference. It allows you to put those big stats on the board. And a lot of that has to do with the defense. It turned in a couple of three and outs to get us ball back to the offense. Turnovers, won the turnover margin there. They're in a good position, but the second half going to be tough.
That penalty number, of course, way too high. 8 penalties so far on NM State. And you go back to that Hawaii game, which was 2 weeks ago, but it was the most recent game. And NM State only committed 4 penalties in that game. So 8 is a really, really high number. And it's even higher when you think about 2 weeks ago.
Yeah, and it's when that happens as well. So some of those on key possessions where you're trying to move the ball and those kind of march you back and kind of let the wind out of your sail. But the third quarter, this is when the coaches are in their keep, get to make the adjustments.
NM State with a gauntlet coming up next. They're going to travel to Alabama and to Kentucky in the next 2 weeks. So they're going to head to back-to-back SEC opponents and then come back home and play UMass on the 27th to finish off the season. Blake Anderson, they're just trying to keep this momentum right now. They've won three in a row, and that's after a two-game losing skid when they fell at home to Boise State and BYU. But this is one of those games where you kind of felt coming in, Danny, it could be a trap game for Utah State because it's not a conference game. They are in first in the Mountain West Mountain Division. It doesn't mean a ton, but they could go to 7-2 if they win it.
Yeah, I think you early on in the week were saying, you know, if they just don't watch out, there could be a situation where we could put them, hold them down a little bit, and we have. But you had a great stat earlier that says they've won some close games. Mm-hmm. So you expect Coach Anderson to make some adjustments and really come after. Same with Coach Martin. We heard it at halftime. Tatiana talked to him and said, hey, we got to get some guys back there to help Jonah, because when he has time, he's been lethal today.
Albertson will kick off to Scarver and Tompkins. Second half is underway from Aggie Memorial. Tompkins will have a return from the one, and he's wrapped up by Torin Union, who's been impactful this year at times in the secondary, and he makes a big play on special teams.
Look how fast Torin Union got downfield when he's able to put himself in a position to sneak under the blocking and just pull the legs out from underneath there. Great tackle, too, where he wraps up both. Did a great job.
Utah State offense will start at the 13 with Logan Bonner, who was 8 for 13 in half one, 73 yards, a touchdown in the thrown interception, which was intercepted by McCullough. Calvin Tyler Jr. is in the backfield. He did not play in the previous two games, but he's back today. Leads the team in carries, rushing yards, and rushing touchdowns with four. Bonner will throw, hauled in by Tompkins up near the 30. That's only his fifth catch, which I say only because he's typically targeted a little bit more.
Yeah, he got past that 1,000 mark the last game, so he's a tough one. You got to keep your eye on. Oh!
Cyrus Dumas jumped the route. He had a pick six in his clearance straight ahead if he could have hauled it in.
Oh, he was going to make a house call right there. He stepped in front of that. It all starts with reading the quarterback. He read the quarterback, read the play, and go position yourself between you and the receiver almost to the house.
Dumas does have two interceptions in little action this year. He's been out with an injury and also wasn't eligible the first couple of weeks. Better pass this time for Bonner, who connects with Justin McGriff. Big hit near midfield. McGriff's first catch today and his 25th this year.
That's tough. You get back in a little zone coverage where you're kind of sitting a little back a bit, and you just leave some holes in there, and he was able to find the hole to sneak into and make the catch there. So you can see right here he's coming across the middle, a little in route, and lots of contact right there, and that was Caleb Mills.
So Mills will leave the game, and Chris Bell comes in for Mills at safety. Mills is having a good finish to his career after transitioning from wide receiver to safety. It was a 19-yard pickup on the previous catch by McGriff. Bonner pulls it on the RPO, has a man downfield, easy toss, hauled in, and a touchdown for Tompkins. His second touchdown today and his eighth of the season.
Big plays always kill us, and it seems like it always gets us when you're least expecting it, which means you're coming out of a turnover, you're coming out of a new set of downs, you're coming out of halftime. In this case, he ran right by us, no one was there, didn't get any overtop help. Maybe that's because, Caleb got hurt, they got some move players in there, and they're going to take a shot downfield, and they did.
54-yard touchdown catch for Tompkins. He had a 22-yarder in quarter two. And the point after is good for Connor Coles. So Tompkins is heating up now, 120 yards receiving, which is just below his season average of 137, good for second best in the country.
You know, lots of blocking back there, so lots of time to throw the ball. And when they have time, both quarterbacks have shown that they've been lethal. And Tompkins, just a matter of time. You were just talking about, you know, hey, he hasn't seen much, has not had huge numbers. There you go.
First lead today for Utah State. Westar is a proud supporter of Aggie Athletics. Find them online at weststarbank.com.
Okay, Adam, at the press conference, coach said, you know what, you're not going to hold them to not score. That's just not going to be possible. This is a good team. So you can kind of see what happens here. Had lots of time, and he just runs right on past us there. And that was that's tough. But coach said, they're going to score. The important thing is for us to volley back and score ourselves. So this is an important set of downs right here.
Yeah, with the way Utah State's been playing offensively, you felt like going into this could be a shootout. This could certainly be a game that is played in the 40s, maybe even the 50s. Utah State scored 51 in their most recent game against Hawaii. Price will take a knee, and the Aggies will start at the 25-yard line. Now they trail 14-13. The defense for New Mexico State, led by Frank Spaziani, has had their moments this year where they played really well. But it's plays like that just changed the whole complexion of the game. You go back to the Hawaii game, last time out. 27-27, the next play defensively for New Mexico State. They gave up a big turn in a big touchdown run by Calvin Turner, and that changed the game on the island. So we'll see if the offense can bounce right back. A hook up there with Andre Bodison on a good pass by Jonah Johnson, and it goes for six.
So, coach, at the halftime break where he was going there and Tatiana grabbed him, he said, hey, we're going to have to try to keep someone back to get a little protection for Jonah. Let's see if that affects the way we start running plays by keeping someone back.
Johnson has spread the ball around well today, and there's nothing there. A tackle for loss from Hale Motuapuaka, junior from Honolulu, who had 1.5 tackles for loss in the game last week for Utah State.
Yeah, that's tough right there. Just blown coverage. We couldn't get to him. Just hard to do anything with that when you get the ball and someone's already on you.
A lot of transfers on this defensive line for Utah State. Transfers from Utah, UCLA, Texas, Michigan, Miami on their D-line. Johnson back to throw, and he's tripped up. That is Byron Vaughns, the Power 5 transfer from Texas, who gets the sack, his third of the season. All three have come in the previous 2 weeks.
So lots of just nose to nose here. We're going to come get you. In this case, he just ducks underneath. He gets pressure from that front side, and there's nothing he could do about it. And just beat the offensive linemen. As much as we said, hey, they've done a great job in Hawaii, first half did a great job this series. They need to make some corrections and try to get back out there and do something. But now it's up to the defense.
Fifth sack for Utah State for a second straight game. And now Carlson will have to punt to Jordan Nathan. He gets it away. A good punt again for Carlson, who's having a great year. Nathan backpedals inside the 35-yard line. A great boot by Josh Carlson, the redshirt sophomore from Gilbert, Arizona. 47-yard punts. Utah State ahead by one with the football. Aggie Memorial Stadium on Military Appreciation Day. That was cool before the game, Denny, that flyover. We were rumbling up here in the TV booth.
Well, that was so awesome.
Very, very cool. Great day for Military Appreciation Day. Adam Young, Danny Nee, Tatiana Favela with you. Second to last home game for NM State. They will be at home on November 27th when they welcome in UMass, a pair of independents going at it. But first, the Aggies will have to travel to Tuscaloosa and to Lexington to play back-to-back SEC programs.
Well, those will be tough games, but those are games that, you know, players want to play in because they want to see what it's like to match up and say, you know what, I have enough to go one-on-one with whoever. So that's a good opportunity to do that. Two good games.
We were talking earlier off the air about a guy like Sage Dockstatter, who certainly has a pro future, a potential NFL draft pick. And if you put good tape together against Bama and Kentucky, that could go a long way. Bonner gets rid of it. Trevor Brohard was crawling towards him. And it's going to bring up second down and 10.
Trevor Brohard, maybe this is a good time to tell his uncle story. Joe Lehocky, who I know from Albuquerque, said his sons were babysitting him, Joe and David Lehocky there, and Trevor and his younger brother were there, and they came home and said, well, how'd it go? And he said, it was good, except for, you know, Trevor, he runs into the wall, falls down, and immediately jumps up and says, is that all you got? I think he was destined to be that hard-hitting linebacker.
And that sounds like Trevor Brohard for sure. Tompkins hangs on. How about that catch?
Oh.
He collided with two black jerseys, and the 5'8" senior from Fort Myers hangs onto the football.
And he got up. Let's watch how high he gets up in the air. So that was good defense. I mean, you have guys on him right there.
Quick slant, incomplete, intended for Derek Wright.
I just remember the Rio Rancho Rocket, Chris Williams, making some of those catches where he would jump, and I promise he would jump, and his feet would be at our shoulder. Tompkins got up, and so now I know when I was talking to the coaches, they were saying, oh, we got to keep our eye on 13. You know, 13 gets the ball, we're in trouble. Yeah, that's right. He's a very good athlete.
It's amazing, too, how he hangs onto the football when there's big-time coverage like that where there was two defenders colliding with him, and he was able to hang on. Logan Bonner throws it across the middle, caught Derek Wright. He makes the catch. Senior out of Sterling, Utah, transfer from Snow, JUCO.
Yeah, that's tough when you're back there. You're in man, and you got your guy, and so you're trying to put pressure on. So you got to be one on one. You don't want to give anything deep, and he let it underneath.
Big run up the middle for Tyler Jr., and he's down to the 11 and a half yard line. Aggies of Utah State driving the football. 19-yard gain on the explosion. Best run today for Tyler Jr., a transfer from Oregon State. They'll mark it at the 11.5-yard line. Tyler still in, and now Bonner will slow things down a bit. This Utah State offense averaging 31 points per game. Bonner will give it. Tyler finds a hole, stays on his feet, and he reaches down to the one. The Aggies had him stop for no gain, and he finds his way down to the one-yard line, and a player is down right now for New Mexico State.
So this is why they say you have to keep your head up. If you put your head down, that's exactly what happens, that you get put in a position where they're throwing a little move on you, and you can't see it because your head is down. Head has to be up at all times. We should have had that tackle in the backfield instead. He pushes it down to the one-yard line.
It was Josh Ferguson who came off the field, and Utah State needs to get back on the field. They were huddled up along the far side. They're moving the football here down to the one-yard line. Tight end Josh Sturzer lined up wing right. Tyler Jr., the tailback. And he's taken down for no gain. That was Michael Bowe Jr. from his money position, Danny.
Yeah, Michael Bowe, we need to call his name more. He was in there. He's a good guy to get involved in this. And so certainly down there at that money spot, you can see him coming in from the outside all the way around, grabs it. But not only that, look at how he's trying to strip the ball, trying to create a turnover. That's a wherewithal of knowing where you are and trying to do something there. I'd like to see that. Like to see a turnover here. That would be great.
Loss of three, so the ball placed at the four. Fourth tackle for loss this season for Bowe Jr. Bonner will throw near side, and it is caught by Wright. Good job of tiptoeing around the sideline. Derek Wright hauls in his sixth touchdown catch of the season, second best on the team. And that's also his eighth career.
So one-on-one, so you know what's happening, especially when you're up against Tompkins. You know that he's going to be getting the ball, and you try to play him where you're not giving him the inside, so you're playing where he has to go out, and they throw the fade, and just tough.
Point after from Connor Coles, grad senior from Bozeman, Montana. And it is good. So it was 13-7 New Mexico State at halftime. And Utah State has scored 14 unanswered in the first 5-plus in half two. Blake Anderson, Utah State Aggies, they've come out here in half two like a different team, Danny Nee. 21-13 the score. Utah State has scored 14 unanswered to start this third quarter, and now this game has shifted a little bit here at Aggie Memorial.
It has, and you saw Coach Bell there. He's our secondary coach, and our coach was down there trying to coach him up on, you know, things you can do, technique you can have. He was in good position. It was just two good players going at it. I mean, it's tough, and Coach Bell, when I spoke with him earlier in the week, he said, you know, these guys are going to be challenged, and I'm up for it. Let's challenge our guys because they can stand up and be called upon to do something big. So now they have to step back into this, forget that. Going forward, they got to watch what they're doing. Only one score down, though. It makes it feel like it's so much more because they scored two really quick, right? One score, though.
Utah State Bowl eligible for the ninth time in the previous 11 years already here in early November. Elliot Nimrod kicking off for the Aggies of Utah State. No return for Juwan Price. NM State has had one offensive series so far in this half. Didn't do much. Offense was clicking pretty much the entire first half. Jonah Johnson 21 for 28 for 180, but no touchdowns. Johnson has run the ball a lot as well. He's netted 18 yards, 32 on the ground for Juwan Price. Six receivers have at least two catches. Ball at the 25-yard line. NM State trailing by eight. Still technically a one-possession game. But now the offensive line, and this dates back to the end of the second quarter. The offensive line is giving Johnson no time.
They set up, and they have a one-high safety, and it usually means it's going to be man everywhere. And so Jonah thinks, okay, this is a chance. Now they're going to blitz someone, and they did, that he could step by him and make some big plays. If he broke the tackle, he would make some big yards, but it didn't work out that way.
It was a loss of one. More time here for Johnson, but he airmails Andre Bodison. He had his target, just could not connect. But now in the back of his mind, Danny, Johnson feels like he probably has to hurry a little more than he does because he's been pressured so much.
Right, so that's where the mistakes can happen when you start to pressure him a bit. And, of course, that's what Utah State is trying to do, is put more pressure on him so he doesn't have time to make the right decision or read.
NM State 4 for 10 on third down. It's third and 11. Heavy rush from Utah State. It comes up the middle as well, and the pass is incomplete. Johnson was looking for Bodison again, and now this Utah State defense, which struggled early on in half one, they're starting to play with some confidence as well.
And you can kind of see what they're doing. They're starting to line up, and then they'll start moving people in and out and start jumping into gaps and moving back and then have someone else step in there. And the whole idea is confuse the offensive line so they don't know where you're coming, but still bring the pressure. And the pressure is what's really getting tough there because he has no time to sit back there and make the read and throw the ball. So that's their objective. So that's what they're doing. So now it's important for Coach Martin to get back and say, fine, how do we get him out of that? How do we get him back into something we can manage?
Third punt of the day for Carlson. And a fair catch is called for by Jordan Nathan. Punt of 40 yards for Carlson. He was averaging 47 per punt of the day before that one. Utah State football once again, 8:50 left in quarter three. High school students, New Mexico State's scholarship priority date is fast approaching. You must apply and be admitted before December 1st to be considered for the school's top scholarships. Do not delay. Go to apply.nmsu.edu. New Mexico State University, be bold, shape the future. Adam Young, Danny Nee, Tatiana Favella with you from Aggie Memorial Stadium. Our director today is Vinny Conway. Our producer, Rita Rodriguez. Engineer, Alex Ramirez. Anthony Casal, our talent stats with us. 21-13. It's been a good ball game. Utah State has gone in front, and they've outscored New Mexico State 14-0 here in the third quarter. And they have the football once again. And this offense for Utah State, Danny, it's looked different here in the second half, hasn't it?
Yeah, they've come back and had one explosion play and then just took another series and methodically just went all the way down the field completely different.
Now, Elion Noah, sophomore running back in the backfield with the quarterback Bonner, and he'll get the carry on first down. He runs it up to the 40-and-a-half-yard line. A gain of 4.5. Still haven't seen Gentry or Pilate Makakona. Noah last week, 23 carries, a career-high 111 against Hawaii. Bonner will throw on second down. He had Tompkins, who might have actually been out of bounds early on in the route. And they're going to say it was caught by Devin Tompkins, who was tiptoeing around that sideline. He hauls it in for 17.
Yeah, that's a tough one back there because they found a big hole right in there, right in between. And I think everyone was saying, no, he was out. But they called him in. They had an official was right there.
Danny, that was big-time footwork by Devin Tompkins because the entire route, it seemed like he was out of bounds, even when he caught it.
It's just tiptoeing the whole way. You couldn't really tell from here, but, yeah, that was a good route.
Here goes this Utah State offense with some tempo.
That's just amazing right there. I'd watch him. I'd put someone on him. Make sure you keep an eye on him.
When they're playing well, they're playing fast offensively. Tompkins is open near side. Bonner finds his roommate, Brandon Bowling. And Utah State inside the red zone. Bowling's been quiet, only his third catch, but that's his 66th of the season.
Part of what happens between the first half and the second half, the first half we had lots of pressure on Logan. He wasn't able to sit back there comfortably, make these passes. And now we just can't get to him. Or he's getting rid of the ball faster, and by doing that, he's having time to find his guys downfield, and they are just marching down the field again.
Ball is down to the 16 of New Mexico State. Aggies creeping up and showing some pressure here. Noah finds a hole on the edge, and he's finally pushed out of bounds inside the 10. Caleb Mills got an arm on him. Gain of 7 for Elion Noah.
You can see him coming on in and just start packing the box. And the idea is that, look, we're not going to let you run the ball here and shut it down. And we did a pretty good job right there. But they are still getting positive yards and sets up a second and short. Somehow they need another stop, another turnover, something.
That game last week against Hawaii was the first career 100-yard rushing game for Noah. He had a career-long 36-yard run on the first play of the game last week. They pull it. Bonner will stay with it, and he runs it down to the 7. That was Tompkins, who they faked it to, and I think if they gave it to Tompkins, he might have been able to run it in for a score.
Yeah, I think you're right. But that's a good read nonetheless, and so that when he has that, you have an opportunity for a strip sack, which is really what we need, something big to happen.
Third down and 1. This is certainly 4-down territory for Utah State. Noah motions out wide, empty backfield, and they will blow the play dead as a flag comes in. Aggies of NM State highly penalized in half 1. Derek Anderson
offside,
is a referee.
Number 91 of the defense, unabated to the quarterback. The penalty is half the distance to the goal, results in a first down.
That's our Justin Segura, redshirt sophomore from Scottsdale, Arizona Horizon High School. He knew it all the way.
Yep.
So a fresh set of downs. First and goal now for Utah State from the 4. 4 out wide. And a flag comes in.
Delay of game, disconcerting signals. Number six of the defense. Penalty is half the distance to the goal. First down.
We've seen that call a number of times this year. This one's on Michael Bowe. I've heard that call at least three or four times this year, Danny.
Yeah. I think what happens when you get down there and the quarterback's using his voice to pull you off and do other things and you start to pair it back or do things, and they call you for, you know, getting in there and interrupting.
Noah the tailback. Three receivers top side of the screen. Tompkins, McGriff, and Bowling. Bottom side is right. Bonner will keep it, and Michael Bowe Jr. wasn't fooled one bit.
That's a great job by Michael Bowe there. He saw what happened. He broke down, so he wasn't out of position. His body was underneath him to make a tackle. So there he is. He breaks down and says, no, you can't go outside or inside. I have you pegged. Nothing he can do. That's a great job right there.
Second tackle for loss today for Bowe. He had three tackles for loss in the first eight games. Also, three fumble recoveries this year for the redshirt senior out of Plantation, Florida. Five and change left in quarter number three. Utah State has outscored NM State 14-0 here in the third. Noah up the middle, and a second effort gets him in. Touchdown run of 4 yards for El Elyon Noah, his third during his sophomore season.
Yeah, hard to tell from here, but it looks like we had him stopped initially, but he just kept driving through there and was able to push that across the goal line. Yeah, just continued to drive. You can see right there, he didn't have a knee go down or anything. He just kept putting his hand down and driving through.
They will double check this, though, to see if his knee was down, I would assume, before he reached for the goal line. So the officials will review this. And once again, our referee today is Derek Anderson, who's leading the charge on the crew. That was Dylan Early, who came in late. Hard to tell, Danny,
yeah,
if his knee was down or not.
I can't tell. It didn't look like it from here, but it's hard to tell at this angle.
And the call on the field is touchdown, so if there's not enough evidence to change it, then it will stay, and it's going to be 27-13 Utah State. It was 13-7 New Mexico State at halftime. 54-yard touchdown catch by Tompkins early on in this quarter. 4-yard touchdown catch by Derek Wright. And now, for the moment, a 4-yard touchdown run by El Elyon Noah.
Looks like his knee is actually on the defender itself and never touched the ground, which you can do, and you can just keep driving through there, which he knew that and put his hand down and just kept driving through.
Looks like the officials have the call.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands. Touchdown.
So 8 plays, 64 yards, covering 342. Touchdown run of 4 yards for Noah. Such a good start for New Mexico State in the first quarter especially, and really the first half in total. And it's been an entirely different story in the third quarter. Point after from Connor Coles. Cotton Lee, the punter, will hold. And it's 28-13 Utah State. Sports Accessories has the best Aggie gear in town at the best price. Check out their showroom in Las Cruces or visit the online store at theaggieshop.com. Utah State trying to go to 7-2. They're currently in first place in the Mountain West Mountain Division. This is their final non-conference game. They were picked fifth in the Mountain West Mountain Division during the preseason. This is a program that struggled last season during that weird and wacky pandemic year. They were 1-5 last season, now 6-2 this year, in position to go to 7-2, and it's been one of the best win improvements in the country. So Blake Anderson in his first season, Danny, has really flipped things in Logan, Utah.
Yeah, and you can see they're feeling it. They feel like, I have momentum. I'm on my way. He's really turned that program around, and we knew him from Arkansas State, like we talked about earlier. He's a good coach. But it's still only two scores, so we need to put some points on the board this drive.
Nimrod will kick it off, left-footed. And Juwan Price will wisely take a knee. Let's see if this Aggie offense, which has sputtered now the last probably 15 minutes of game time, Danny, going back to late in that second quarter when they had a chance to score some points.
Put some points on, yeah.
And extend their lead right before the break, and they couldn't do it.
They couldn't do it. I think that's when Utah State started mixing up their blitzing, coming in from different angles and different twists and different things, and we're just not picking them up correctly, or have the personnel back there with a back to pick up an extra blitzer.
8 carries for 32 yards today for Juwan Price after 160 last game, and the pass is almost intercepted. Outstanding coverage by grad senior Shaq Bond, who got his hands on the pass.
I think that's one where Jonah came back and set his feet and decided this is where I'm going, and he looked it down the whole time. See him looking right there? He's looking, and there's an extra guy in there, and he sees that and tries to step in front. That's a tough one.
Bond almost had his third pick of the season. Second down and 10 from the 25-yard line. Tons of flags coming in.
False start, number 61, offense. 5-yard penalty, second down.
Rare mistake there for grad transfer Eli Johnson. And it happened right when Utah State was showing blitz, Danny.
Yeah, and I think he's telling them that he's pulling them off because he's in there trying to stomp his feet and do some things that's like, no, I'm not sure. I didn't even see the movement, but.
And that was Vong Pachong, who was speeding towards the line there that forced that false start on Johnson. And Jonah Johnson is belted. That's the danger when you have a quarterback who scampers, is you're trying to keep him protected and keep him healthy, and he took a hit right there.
Yeah, not a lot there. So a lot of energy is being spent trying to figure out the blitzing people and who's coming in. Do we need a back staying back to help out to make sure we give good protection? And we're just not spending as much time trying to figure out, well, who's getting open in the patterns, because there's too much blitzing and twisting and screaming up front there. So we got to figure that out up front to give him time to make some completions.
Third down and a dozen. Here's a completion. Jared Wyatt. First down and then some as he creeps towards midfield.
And that's what happens when you bring the house. When you bring the house, it means you're in one-and-one coverage. If you have enough time, you can see it right here. They're trying to overrun the line with more people than they can block. But Jonah was able to get the ball out to Jared and make a big, big, huge play.
24-yard burst for Wyatt on his third catch of the day.
The ball was not made ready for play. First down.
Utah State's smelling blood right now.
Yeah, they are.
First down and 10, just shy of midfield. NM State trying to work their way back into this one. Johnson looks right, throws right, flag in. Catch made by Cole Harity, who was the busiest man in the field in the first half. His first catch in half two, his ninth for the game, and a man is down for Utah State in addition to the flag.
Offside, number 9, defense, lined up in the neutral zone. 5-yard penalty, replay first down.
That player down for Utah State was Shaq Bond, and then he leaves the field on his own power. Penalty was on Jalen Bannerman. So the Aggies will maneuver into Utah State territory at the 49-yard line of Utah State. Trying to make this a one-score game again. Johnson will throw it again. A little hesitation. Still reeled in, though, by Jared Wyatt, and gets enough for the first down. He needed five. He gets six.
So no blitzing, no anything. They're sitting back in a zone. We're just going to play some base defense for Utah State. And when that happens and everyone is accounted for and Jonah has time, the receivers are finding open spots to sit down. And he's been great on finding those people. It's when they bring the blitz that's when it starts making really trouble for that line.
Alex Escobar, the running back alongside Johnson. Underneath, good catch, Andre Bodison. I don't know how
did he get that off?
Hold on to it.
Yeah, or can't make the catch too. Lots of pressure, Jonah. They're bringing a linebacker that came untouched, and he got rid of the ball immediately. That's what I thought you were talking about. How did he get the ball out without getting knocked down? But Andre also made a good catch, going quick.
Bodison gets eight. Escobar trying to run for the first down, and looks like he has enough to move the chains.
Number 21,
needed
Alex
two, and he gets
Escobar
two, and then maybe a few more inches past that. And the chains will move for a first down, or will they not? The spot looked good.
Wow.
The line judge hasn't moved it yet. It seems like it's enough.
Ruling on the field is a first down, yeah. New Mexico State.
That's what I thought.
For the
I was with you. It's like, wait a minute, what?
Doing
they got the first. Hey, that was great blocking up front too. So I know Alex got the ball and got to that first down marker, Escobar. But it was a great hole created by that offensive line. So there's some goodness in there still. So they just got to find it. Just look for more pressure coming up.
A couple carries today for Escobar. Omari Samuels has played, and he's only had one carry. Johnson dragged down there by Patrick Joyner Jr., his third sack of the season, the former Miami Hurricane.
Not a lot going on. Didn't have a lot of guys in the pattern, so we have lots of people blitzing. We said it was coming. Juwan, that was his responsibility to pick up that block. Had the initial contact, but they just won't be denied, which is a little bump. You got to get in there and really rough them up. And I think that's why they bring Alex in there from time to time, because he's a good blocker.
Another big loss of 5 yards there for Johnson on the sack. With his toes on the 50, he'll dart ahead looking for a blocker. Flag was thrown, and he's taken down by Andre Grayson. And there's been a ton of penalties here in this third quarter.
Offside, number 9, defense. 5-yard penalty, replay, second down.
Bannerman again.
I think that's what happens when you start being super aggressive, which they were. I'm sure Coach Anderson was all over him saying, look, you're going to have to turn it up a little bit, and you get aggressive on that line and you start varying the count a bit. That can happen. I also think it's a good time for screens and other things that's happening. If you can just pick the right time where they're bringing the house and dump it over top, but it's all about timing.
Johnson from the 38, sideline wide open. That's Juwan Price, the running back, who didn't have anybody around him.
Thought he was going to try to come back inside and make something big out of it. I think the right idea was to take that positive yardage down the sidelines and just step out like he did.
9 yards picked up there by Price. It looks like he's going to be
third down for New Mexico State.
About a yard shy of the first down. Third down and a long one. We'll call it a two, but it looks like a long one here for Jonah Johnson. Whitford was alongside him. They didn't use him, and Johnson is wrapped up. It'll be a loss of one on the play, and, well, now if you're New Mexico State offensively, you have to go for it here, right, Dan?
Yeah, I think so. This is where you need points. You need 7. You can't go back to 3. So let's see what happens in there. This is a draw all the way, and nothing doing. We had two guys on him and still couldn't get the block done, and that's just pure aggression up front. Bull rushing, trying to bust the tackle, get an arm between the two guys, and shimmy back in there for that sack.
NM State 5-for-14 this year on fourth down. Catch is made. Terrell Warner. And the Aggies have a first down. Big play for the Louisiana native.
Wow, that's tough right there. Jonah with lots of patience back there. He's got a little ice in those veins back there because lots of pressure, and he's just staying calm. Seeing Terrell across the middle, hits him, gets that first down on fourth down.
drive will continue for New Mexico State. Dodge City Community College transfer Terrell Warner extends it as we head to the fourth. Back with you here at Aggie Memorial Stadium, Adam Young alongside Grandpa Danny Knee, Weston Scott Knee, born on October 16th. How cool is this, Danny? Congratulations, my man.
Just choked up here. There's my son Jordan and his wife Diana had their first Weston Scott Knee. Welcome to the knee pad roster. We can't wait to have a good group huddle with everyone to bring him in here. They're fantastic and just love them to death. Weston, welcome, bud.
I know Jordan's watching football with him probably today, isn't he?
He was at the Army game earlier, but they're watching now. We have him already. We're already recruiting him hard. Getting him on that roster early is what we're trying to do.
I love it.
Good stuff. Thank you, guys.
Weston Scott Knee, born on October 16th. Congrats to you, Danny, your wife, Sarah, and then, of course, your son, Jordan, your daughter-in-law, Diana. Really, really cool.
Thank you guys so much. Yeah, I was so proud of him. It's tough, and I thanked him for the birthday present. He said, I didn't get you anything on your birthday. I said, no, you did, dude. The best thing in the world.
Yeah.
So all good stuff. They're all healthy, and so I'm happy for everyone. So
I love it.
Thank you guys so much. I appreciate it.
Congrats, partner. Very, very cool. I know Weston wants a New Mexico State touchdown right now, doesn't he, Danny?
He does.
Danny, a former defensive back for New Mexico State, and I should have known that he would have an Aggie helmet already.
Oh, hey, yo.
Should have known that.
We're trying to recruit him hard already.
All right, here we go. Terrell Warner with a big catch and run to extend the drive down to the 8-yard line. It is first and goal. This is a big, big possession right here for New Mexico State to try to stay in this game. Juwan Price, the tailback. He scored an 11-yard touchdown run earlier. Jonah Johnson will keep it. Maneuvers up to the 5-yard line, so he does pick up 3. Time really not an issue yet, so
it's not
to punch it in.
No, but you certainly you got to get 7, right? So we can't walk out of here with a field goal right now. You got to put 7 on the board, so you do have 3 more downs to pick that up.
NM State has not scored a touchdown since the first quarter. A touchdown and 2 field goals in this game. Johnson has options. He could have pitched it to Price. He chooses to keep it. And there's no gain on the play. Maybe he got inches, but that's all.
Looked like an option he was running there, right? And decided to just keep it. So this is where I think he's thinking, well, if they were going to bring the house and bring everyone, they're not going to count for the pitch guy. But you can see someone was out on Juwan, and nothing was going to happen with that pitch.
Johnson wasn't ready for the snap from Johnson. Eli Johnson, the center. Jonah Johnson, the quarterback. And fortunately, Jonah jumps on it, but it's about to be fourth down now.
Yeah,
he's just wasted it out.
Yeah, look, and Eli knows it too, and so they just mixed up. Not too many mistakes that he has like that, but certainly that's one that's going to hurt him too, because that was a down wasted. Then so you take the last 2, didn't get a lot of yardage, put you in a position of fourth down where you got to punch it in here with working down in the fourth.
Loss of 2 on the play. So now it's fourth and goal from the 7. Johnson will have to throw. He throws, and it's bobbled and incomplete. Great coverage. Terrell Warner almost snatched it, and NM State turns it over on downs from the 5-yard line initially.
That's too bad. So you're running a little skinny post in here. That's the good one, or slant in there. That's the good one to pick because you have the defender behind you. Jonah puts the ball in front where you should, but clearly the defender got his arm underneath there and didn't allow that reception. So that's a tough one to not walk away with points on for sure.
That's big-time coverage there in the end zone from senior Zahadri Jackson, cornerback out of Sarasota, Florida. And now NM State defensively will look for a takeaway or just a 3-and-out right here to stay in this game. Logan Bonner back at quarterback for Utah State. from his own end zone. Home run ball down the sideline. Tompkins is there. What a grab. This kid's unbelievable.
I'm speechless, Adam, as we stand up here and he throws that ball all the way up. Clearly, that's a 50-50 ball the coach was talking about in the press conference. Says they throw a ton of them. Look at his arm, too, by the way. He lets this thing rip. We're in good position, right? That's good coverage right there. You're right there on him, 50-50, and he just goes up. It's amazing.
He's 5'8", 155 pounds, and he does not play
false start. Everybody but the center. Offense. 5-yard penalty. First down.
Here's the pass. It's a bomb. He just lets this thing just fly. I mean, we're in good position. We're right there. That's DJ. He's already have a pick already, but and he knows it. I'm right there. I'm being challenged. I got their best receiver. I'm one-on-one, and he just got him this time, and that's just what happens from time to time. And so, hey, he's still got a ball game. He's still going to get in here and shut him down.
Over 1,000 yards receiving this year for Tompkins, team leader in catches, receiving yards, and touchdowns. Sidestepping out of bounds is Tyler Jr. To average 137 receiving yards per game. That is unreal. That's second best in the country.
You know, when Coach was talking about the 50, and several of the coaches that I spoke to said, you know, he'll throw up a lot of 50-50 balls. I think now I know why. Because when you have someone that's so dynamic that can make a play, you got a great percentage. It's just all statistics, right?
Ball at the 45-yard line, second and 13. Bonner has to get rid of it quickly. He does, and the Aggies are right there. Good tackle by Cyrus Dumas, bringing down Derek Wright, who caught a touchdown pass of 4 yards in quarter three.
Cyrus looks fired up here. So here he is right there, quick dump to the outside. They're looking to get some extra yardage and get a blocker, extra blocker that's going to go get him. Cyrus has had nothing to do with that. He closes down so fast on that, couldn't get a block on it.
Original line of scrimmage is the 42. Ball at the 44. Third and a dozen. Bonner, 18 for 26 today, 299, 3 touchdowns, and a pick. Interception came from DJ McCullough. Utah State 0 for 3 on third down. They haven't had many. Bonner tosses, catches made, first down. That's Kyle Van Leeuwen, the sophomore out of Provo, Utah, where BYU is located.
Yeah, I'm trying to tighten up this defense a little bit so you can't let them have some of those. That's I think that's early out there on the coverage that with that. Lots of pressure, going to get them on pressure, and you just got to close it down and not let them have that. That's a nice pitching catch, though.
15-yard connection. They needed 12 to get 15. Drive will continue for Utah State. Under 11 left in the fourth. Logan Bonner slowing things down. Hands it off to Noah. Explodes straight up the middle. Good first down run there for El Elyon Noah. That's his team high 10th carry of the day. He's gone for 38. NM State's done a pretty good job today against the run, Danny.
They have. They've done quite well. I mean, and they only have 28 points, and so they're still holding them to a spot, but you got to score some points offensively. But they're a good team.
Damage has been done through the air. Through the air again. Noah's wide open with space. He cuts it up the middle, and he rumbles down to the 5-yard line. It's going to be first down and goal for Utah State, trying to extend their lead.
First and goal.
He had pressure coming, and so he was just able to scramble out of the pocket and find Noah, who was open, wide open, because everyone was back in coverage. No one covering someone out of the backfield, and there he is, picks up some good yardage.
17-yard catch and run for Noah. Only his fifth catch all season. Tight end Carson Terrell is in the formation to the left of the line. They give it to Noah. Second effort, reaching for the goal line. No signal yet.
Noah on the carry.
You're going to mark him short.
And he's going to be inches short of the goal line. Inside the one.
Number
And Utah State's okay to use some clock here as well. Clock moves. Under 9 minutes to go before they snap it. They've also dominated time of possession here in this second half. Brohard with the pressure. That's a loose ball, or is it an incomplete pass? It probably
That's
should be an incomplete pass.
It's an incomplete pass.
Brohard came there, and Bonner got rid of it barely, and it's not really a dangerous play per se because it's incomplete if
right.
it drops on the turf.
Right. But look how fast he got there. It's like, oh, I got to get rid of it before he was ready.
Nothing like Trevor Brohard screaming right in your eyeballs as well.
Yeah.
Third down inside the one. No other running back. They're going to throw it. And it's caught by the 6'6", Justin McGriff. On a third and inches. Utah State hooks up with McGriff. Bonner throws the touchdown, his fourth, and McGriff his sixth career touchdown reception.
You know, again, we're in good position. We're right there. That's Cyrus Dumas on coverage. But at 6'6", it's very tough when the ball is thrown high, and he can catch that at the highest point, and he already starts at 6'6", gets his arms up, and then jumps. It makes it tough.
We've talked about the size of Tompkins, who's only 5'8", Bowling, who's only 5'9". McGriff is that big target for Logan Bonner, standing at 6'6", 215 pounds. In this second half, domination continues for Utah State. Utah State has outscored NM State 28-0 in the half. They now lead 35-13. Memorial Medical Center is the official healthcare partner of Aggie Athletics. Find them online at mmclc.org. Adam Young, Danny Nee, Tatiana Favella with you. And this has been the definition of Tale of Two Halves. NM State led 13-7 at halftime. They led 10-0 after one quarter. But here in half two, Utah State has outscored NM State 28-0. And now you look up and they lead by 22.
So now you're in a position where you have to start taking some risks. How big, and you already said this off camera, but how big was that Cyrus pick that he just couldn't get his arms on? He turns that around and it changes the complexion of the game.
Yeah, Dumas jumped a route early on in the third quarter. If he catches the ball, he runs it in for a pick six, and then it's 20-7 NM State. Instead, he dropped it a few plays later. 54-yard touchdown catch by Tompkins, his first of two really long catches here in this half alone. And you look at the scoreboard, and now it's 35-13. No return for NM State, and they will get the ball at the 25-yard line. Such a tough schedule when you look ahead, too, for NM State, Danny. It gets really, really
hard.
Doesn't
get easy.
Bama and Kentucky in the next 2 weeks, and then you come home and play UMass.
Yep, that's tough, too. Still got to finish this one out. So here's what happens is usually when you know you're down by a bunch, you got to score a whole bunch. So they're going to come back and play a little different coverage, and so they may not choose to go after him as much, although they've affected him quite a bit. But it means you have to start making some big plays and have big chunk plays and not just small ones. So it gets tougher and tougher.
Johnson running left past the line of scrimmage. He will slide. Started his slide up at the 34. It's 9 yards on the run. Total offense for NM State, 299. Utah State 4-15, and it was a big difference in favor of NM State at halftime. That script, of course, has been totally flipped. Juwan Price had a couple long runs in the first half. He gets the first down to move the sticks, a gain of four for the redshirt freshman from Peoria, Arizona.
I think they're going to give him those easy runs, and so they're just in base coverage now, kind of just sitting back. And, you know, if we can break one of those for a long run like they did against Hawaii, that would help a great deal. But you got to have start a little time is of the essence here as well.
Johnson throws, initially caught and then dropped by Jared Wyatt.
Looks like he had it too. Looks like he bobbled it and re-caught it, and then it just couldn't bring it in.
Wyatt, four catches today for 59 yards.
There's a little slant across the middle there, and it just couldn't pull it in. But that's okay because that stops the clock, so now you're able to regroup and figure out what you need to do to get another big chunk play here.
Cole Harity has led the way, eight catches, 72 yards, all in half one, though. Johnson hit as he throws, completes the pass to Andre Bodison, who spins towards the marker, and he has enough for the first down, and Johnson gets up a little bit slowly, but he's okay, and the drive will continue.
That's a great job by Andre. Again, he does this little spin move like a little game or something and picks up that first down.
Just shy of midfield. Front side pressure. There's Cole Harity, his first catch in this half. This one goes for 11. And he's almost in double figures. Nine catches, 83 yards for the Saddleback College transfer.
Yeah, that's tough for Cole because he knows he's going to get popped going across the middle there. And he did bring it in, was able to hold on this time.
Yeah, he was popped pretty hard on one of his near catches in the first half. Out route, hauled in. Andre Bodison with his stiff arm and a few more as he stiff arms Cash Gilliam along the sideline. Move the chains again, gain of 12.
Dump it out quickly, let Andre get as much as he can. Stiff arm, those big long arms, and pick up extra yards.
Alex Escobar is in it running back. Two men coming right at Jonah, and he lofts it out of bounds.
Are you good, go?
That was Marcus Moore and Hale Motuapuaka coming right at Jonah Johnson up the middle.
I think this is where coach believes, hey, they're going to dial up a little pressure. So they played back a little soft, little zone as they march down the field. Now as they get a little closer to the red zone, they could bring some blitzes. They could bring some other things. And so I think that's why. Brought Alex in as the better blocker to see if he can't pick up some of those blitzing people that could be coming right about now.
Bodison in motion, right side of your screen. Johnson will lob it, looking for Bodison. Extra coverage comes, and it was grabbed by Hunter Reynolds, but he was well out of bounds. That was a dangerous pass by Jonah Johnson there in the lob.
Yeah, that's a tough one. That's putting our big guy up against theirs and saying, hey, look, we have someone that's 6'5" that can go up for the ball as well. It's a deep fade route, but the safety came over top there and picked that. Saw it all the while because Jonah just looked at him the minute there was a snap.
Reynolds is down, might be a cramp near the goal line. Transfer from Michigan, a number of Power 5 transfers that are playing a lot right now for Blake Anderson, including Reynolds.
Time out on the field.
Who spent 4 years with the Wolverines, played in 20 games there, and he's having a good year for Utah State, second on the team in tackles. It was a slow start, Danny, for Utah State, but here in this half, you're seeing why they're 6-2 and they're heading to a bowl game already.
Yeah, they made some good adjustments and a play here and there. Seems like the story of the of Aggie, right, this whole year. It's like a play here or there. But they did make some good adjustments. They didn't panic. Once they dialed up the pressure on defense, it just kind of everything started unraveling a little by little.
So Reynolds will head off. And it will be third down and 10 for the New Mexico State offense. In danger here of dropping to 1-8 on the season. Lone win against South Carolina State FCS program. Still looking for that first FBS win. A lot of close games during that recent three-game road stretch. Almost got one against San Jose State. Almost got one against Hawaii in the most recent game. led by 6 today at the break, led by 10 after one quarter. And a timeout is called by Utah State.
Timeout, Utah State. Their first of the half. Media timeout.
35-13, 6:37 for quarter four here at Aggie Memorial. Utah State leads New Mexico State here at Aggie Memorial Stadium. Today's game is presented by First Light Federal Credit Union. Simple, safe, secure. Give First Light the opportunity to show you what better really is. The Aggies have a number of coaches who played here, including Oliver Sukup. For more on that, we send it down to Tatiana Favela.
Switching it up from the players to the field to the coaches on the sideline, assistants head coach Oliver Sukup heading along alongside head coach Doug Martin's side. Now he looks over the linebackers of this team, and like you said, he's a former team captain himself and is on his 7th season on New Mexico State coaching staff this year. Now his linebacker unit has been consistently leading the Aggie defense on the field. Fun fact, during Sukup's time as team captain during the 2000 season, he was also named to the Progressive All-American Farm Team as a senior. Adam, Danny.
Thank you, Tatiana. All sideline reports are brought to you by Memorial Medical Center. And third down and 10 play there. And another sack for this Utah State defense, Danny.
Yeah, I think they saw enough of letting Jonas sit back there and pick him apart. And so they were going to dial up some pressure. And so which we kind of thought as they moved down a little closer to the red zone, they were going to dial more pressure. So. And it's not even ready to get rid of the ball. There's nowhere to go with the ball, and the pressure is on you so fast, you almost have to just, it's a loss down.
Sacked by Bond for a loss of 7. NF State has to go for it now on 4th and 17. They need the 18-yard line. Good pass, good catch, but it's going to be short. Outstanding grab by Terrell Warner.
Yeah, Terrell's showing he's got little hops as well. He went up for that one nice and high and got it. Fortunately, they had some good tackling. They're back there in a safety prevent kind of defense where they're not going to give anything deep. But look at Terrell get up there and get that ball and hang on to it. He knows he's going to get popped, and he hangs on to it anyway. Pulls up short, but great catch. I think he's feeling it just a bit.
Yeah, fourth catch today for Warner. That is a turnover on downs, though. Under 6 left here in the fourth. We'll see if Utah State makes any changes of note. Looks like Bonner is going to stay in. I thought maybe they would bring in Andrew Peasley, their backup, who's actually seen a decent amount of action this year when Bonner has been injured. But it looks like they will stick with their starters. It's Bonner at quarterback and Noah at running back. Team high 11 carries for 42 yards for Noah, and he's going to see the ball a lot here late in this game as Utah State tries to run some clock. Gain of 4 for Noah.
Yeah, I think right now it's just going to be grinded out. They're just going to give it a give and go, and let's just keep the clock spinning and just try to push them back and get our guys up front against your big guys and push them around a little bit and chew the clock.
Neither team has had success on the ground. Utah State's only averaging 3.6 per rush. NM State's only run it for 49 yards on the day, 1.4 per rush. Right back to Noah, sprints towards the sideline, and he's dragged down by Nick Giacalone. Caleb Mills also there. And it brings up third down and short after a 2-yard pickup. Utah State will have San Jose State next weekend as they head back to Mountain West play. The Aggies of Utah State, 4-1 this year in Mountain West play. No loss game against Boise State at home. And they're going to improve to 4-0 in the row. Flag in, looks like the Aggies crossed. Bonner will throw, and he hooks up there with Brandon Bowling, who just like Bonner is a transfer from Arkansas State. Came over with head coach Blake Anderson.
I think the Aggies
offside,
are
number 48, defense.
That penalty is declined. The result of the play is a first down.
I think Coach brings in Eric Marsh and Nick Jacklone, get some time, do some things in there, and you know we're just trying to pressure them a little bit and show that we're going to come in and pull out of it, and I think it just stepped across there and got in the neutral zone.
Too many penalties today for NM State. Way too many. Noah again. A plunge forward. Brought down by Chris Ojo. 4-yard sprint there for Noah.
Yeah, a lot of penalties. Think about all the times we've missed counts or there was an offsides and defense where we're jumping, you know, or offense where they're coming in there and we jump because we're not sure of who's got who. And there's just a lot of miscues in there, and those are the tough ones.
And NM State recently, in their last couple of games, they haven't had miscues like that. They've had them here today for sure. Noah breaks a tackle, and he dives across midfield, and his knee might have touched down a yard shy of the yardage needed. He needed 6, he gets 5. 3rd and 1 now. Utah State, in the final couple weeks of the regular season, they're going to try to hunt down a Mountain West title. In a good spot right now in the Mountain West race. They're going to stay on the road, San Jose next weekend, which they maybe prefer. They've lost both of their games this year in Logan at home. And they're going to stay undefeated away from home. Noah, he'll be short, Danny.
Yeah. It was good defense, good pressure defense. We're in the gaps there, trying to shoot the gaps in there. I don't know if that was Donovan King made that initial hit inside there, but I think they are. Yeah, it's interesting. It's a tale of two halves, right? Because the first half, so different. It seems like we went up and down the field with ease and a lot of things happening, positive, and then it just kind of all twisted.
4th and 1, Utah State will go for it. Flag comes in. Aggies are offsides again, I believe. Passes tipped around and then dropped by Bowling. And we'll see what the flag is about from Derek Anderson.
48 defense. It's a 5-yard penalty. Results in a first down.
That's twice. Eric Marsh, Buckeye, Arizona native linebacker, crossing that line trying to show some pressure.
Yeah. I think the rule is basically when you do something once in a game, okay. When you do it twice, I think the coaches will find that and ride you a bit. So that's tough.
That's 14 penalties now are New Mexico State, and Utah State not a whole lot better. They've been penalized 8 times. 14 penalties for 101 penalty yards. That can totally change a game, right?
Yeah.
It was John Gentry on the carry, his first today. Sophomore out of Houston. 55 carries for 204 coming in.
I know that the coach has got some other guys coming in and out there, and I know we did a little thing on Sue Cup. Coach Sue Cup, he's a great guy. And Adam, before the game, we saw his boys come down there and give him some high fives and some love before the game started. His wife, who was due in December here, and just a great guy. He's a great Aggie.
His kids had black football jerseys on with Sue Cup on the back. Really cool. Gentry again, his second straight rush. We have not seen Pailate Makakona today, who last week had a career-high 15 carries for a career-high 22 yards against Hawaii. Chris Ojo's still playing, that's for sure. He's not going to give up.
Yeah, he's still fired up. I like it.
Ojo's had a really good year, leading the Aggies in numerous categories. Tackles for loss, sacks, forced fumbles, and 2nd down and 7 for Utah State now. We'll take a break. Final minute 22 when you come back. Final minute 22 from Aggie Memorial Stadium. Blake Anderson in his first year at Utah State. His Aggies will leave with their 7th win of the season. They accomplished bowl eligibility a week ago with their win against Hawaii. They're going to go to 4-0 now on the road. Impressive win early on in the year in Pullman, at Washington State. Also road wins at Air Force and at UNLV. And despite a good first quarter and overall a pretty good first half, NM State will fall to 1-8 on the season. 3rd and 8 for Utah State. John Gentry off the right hip of the quarterback Bonner, who's thrown 4 touchdown passes today. He's tied his career high for a second straight game. Whistles a pass far side, caught by Savon Scarver. And it's good enough for a first down. Scarver with his second catch of the day. He only had 3 catches for the season coming into this one.
You know, in spite of the record, as I talked to all the coaches this week, trying to get going, kind of get ready, trying to figure out what's the plan, I asked about the players. You know, what are they like at practice? And all of them agreed that, you know, these are good college athletes that they don't give up. They're just because of the record. They're there busting their tail every day at practice, and I appreciate that.
That's a good point, Danny. Doug Martin has said if you come out to a practice and don't know what the record is, they're not practicing like a 1-7 football team. They're practicing like a team that's still fighting for something,
right?
No question about it. And this is a tough spot too, when you know you're not going to be bowl eligible, you're not in the league, so you're not going towards a conference championship. You're playing those final 3 games after today for film, and you're doing it because you're playing at this level too. You're playing at the FBS level,
right?
This is an opportunity a lot of people would really want to have.
Yeah, it's a gut check to see, you know, are you all in or not? If you're just going to be in when things are good, are you in when things aren't so good? And it's a good gut check.
Gentry trying to bounce it to the edge. And Jacqueline and Brohard trying to throw him down like a wrestler.
Yeah, I think Brohard was up there saying, yeah, is that all you got? Just like the story. It was like, that's a great story. It just appears that he's that way all the time. It's all go, all gas. Let's get it done. Whistle to whistle.
So the clock will run out. Utah State improves to 7-2. Their win streak is extended to 4 straight wins. New Mexico State loses their 5th in a row. And Doug Martin's crew is now 1-8 on this season. NM State will have Alabama, second-ranked team in the country, and then Kentucky. Kentucky's in the top 20. And then come home on November 27th to play UMass, and Utah State will get back to conference play as they travel to San Jose and play San Jose State next weekend. Just need to play 4 quarters, Danny. We said that after the first quarter, we'll see if the Aggies of NM State could keep their foot on the gas pedal, and just could not do so.
Yeah, it couldn't happen today, but, you know, the game plan is a good, solid game plan. Had a couple breaks that didn't just come our way, and it seems like that was just the case on a lot of games this year. And he just couldn't get those breaks, and consequently, it kind of turned the game on us a little bit.
Doug Martin is standing by on the field with Tatiana Favela.
Hey, Adam, now joined with Coach Doug Martin. Coach, what do you think that you can build on from this game moving forward?
Well, you know, we played a good half of defense, a good half of offense, but you got to play 2 on each side. That's kind of been our problem all year long. So, but guys are playing hard, they're working hard.
And anything moving forward you want to focus on?
Well, again, it's just being able to play a full game. You know, we play in spurts, and you got to be able to play a whole game.
Thank you so much, Coach. Adam, Danny, back to you guys.
Thank you, Tatiana. Thank you to Coach for stopping by. All reports are brought to you by Memorial Medical Center. Final score, 35-13. Utah State to victory. Nusenda postgame comes up next.